gentlemen, we are live for another week of Sioux City Bandits football here in the National Arena League. I am Braden Butler. Thank you for joining me for another edition of Bandits football, taking on a familiar foe, the same team they faced back in week one, the Oklahoma Flying Aces. These two teams look a little different than last time we saw them face off on March 15th, though. Looking back at that one, the Bandits did get a victory in that league opener, 37-24. It was the 100th career victory for head coach Irv Strobing. It also saw offensive coordinator Scott Jensen suit back up one last time for the Sioux City Bandits and throw his 200th career touchdown pass. Oklahoma 0-1 after that loss. First game came on only 3 days of practice back on March 15th, and they did not have a quarterback on the roster. Wide receiver Torrence Carr Young stepped in. He threw for over 100 yards and 3 touchdowns, but it's going to be a different team this week with a full roster and full preparation than the Bandits saw in week one. They're announcing the game day roster for the Sioux City Bandits right now, so let's go over that one. It's already part of the way through it. First of all, it's Agent Zero, number zero, the defensive back Justin Gilbert, 6 foot tall out of Oklahoma State University. Next up, number one, the defensive back Xavier Spann, 6'1", 190 out of Morningside. Number two, the wide receiver of the franchise himself, Fred Bruno, stands 5'8", 210 out of Wayne State. Number four, wide receiver Sammy Epp, standing at 6 feet, 4 inch tall, 215 pounds. They're giving Braden Mines his own special entrance here, so we'll get to him in just a second. But also on today's game day roster, defensive back Carlton Watkins wearing the number five. Number six, a new face. You might need to learn this name. He's going to get some carries today. The running back, Landon Freeman, 5'10", 195 out of the University of Sioux Falls. Now we get to the Swiss Army Knight himself. Number 10, the linebacker, Braden Mines, 6 foot tall, 230 pounds out of Simpson College. And now coming out right now, Randall Blash, number 11, the 6'1", 320-pound defensive lineman out of Shorter University. Now we'll talk about them as they come out live here. Ossie Tapua, the next man out of the tunnel. Number 12 tonight, 6'3", 235 pounds out of Briar Cliff University. Had 4 tackles and half a sack in week one. Tyler Lonstein out next out of the tunnel. The quarterback today wearing the number 13, 6'2", 215 pounds out of York, did not play in week one. Back in the preseason game for the Bandits, he did have 84 yards passing and 2 touchdowns, completed 62.5% of his passes. Next man out of the tunnel is a guy who did not play in week one either. But he is an X factor for this Sioux City Bandits team as the wide receiver, number 14, Brandon Shepard, stands 6'3", 205 out of Oklahoma State. Part of the recruiting team, if you want to call it. They got Justin Gilbert to town for Sioux City. Also very, very good at that wide receiver position. Averaging a touchdown per game in his Bandits career. Out next is Zach Slugger. We're the number 17, the linebacker returning to the Sioux City Bandits today. 6'2", 245 out of Morningside College. Next one out, another quarterback for this Sioux City Bandits team. It's Joshua Hollins. He's wearing number 18 today, 6'2", 200 pounds. Has experience at the CIF level. I was told expect to see a little bit of him and Lonstein today. Next one out of the tunnel, the local man out of Briar Cliff, Drew Prohaska, the 5'8", 190-pound running back. As a running back teammate today with Landon Freeman getting his first appearance for the Bandits, but Prohaska has been the bell cow for a while now for this Sioux City organization. Next man out, number 21, the defensive back Antonio Pierce. He stands 6 foot, 1 inch tall, 180 pounds. Did not record any stats in week one, but has been a member of this Bandit secondary going into his second year. Did have last year cut short with injury, however. Out next is number 26, the long arm of the law for the Sioux City Bandits is Devin Groenhagen, the 6 foot tall, 260 pound defensive lineman out of Morningside College. Long time Sioux City Bandit. Been a difference maker, had a great week one as well. 5 tackles in that one, half a sack, and 1.5 tackles for loss. Next man out, wide receiver number 27 is Jakari Christian out of Dakota State University. He stands 6 feet, 1 inch tall, 210 pounds. Aaron Roundtree out next. 6'1" tall, 210 pounds out of Tusculum University. Has previous experience in the AAL. Defensive back for him, number 28 today. The only guys left on the roster now are the big boys, your three offensive linemen. So we're going to see some trench warriors coming out of the tunnel. Starting with 6'4", 310 pound Omar Roberts, wearing the number 55 today out of Carthage College. He's a rookie in the indoor football game and the arena football game as well here in the National Arena League. Next man out has been a staple of the indoor game at the in the trenches for a while for multiple teams. Made his way to Sioux City, has experience in the IFL as well. It's Sterling Clark, 6'6", 325 pounds out of Wilmington College. And lastly, but certainly not least, also standing 6'6", 325, it is Stephen Fluker, coming out to Batista's theme song out of the WWE, if you're familiar with him. Some of you might be familiar with him as an actor now, but fitting today on night one of WrestleMania, Stephen Fluker coming out to Batista's theme song. Let's get a little more background on both these teams. Did mention earlier that Bandits won their week one matchup against Oklahoma 37-25 on March 15th. Brandon Shepherd did not play for Sioux City. Oklahoma played wide receiver Torrance Carr-Young at quarterback, so both teams have a few different pieces now than they had in that week one matchup. Some key stats in that one, starting with the Bandits. Fred Bruno had 113 all-purpose yards, one touchdown reception, and one kick return for a touchdown. Defensively, Braden Mintz led the way with 9 tackles, 1.5 tackles for loss, a sack. He also had 14 yards rushing, a rushing touchdown. He handled kickoffs. He's going to handle PAT attempts today. He's the Swiss Army knife. That's all I can say about him. He has earned that nickname by being willing and able to do it all for the Sioux City Bandits. For Oklahoma, Torrance Carr-Young was at quarterback. The wide receiver today stepped in an emergency situation, had 102 yards passing, 3 touchdowns and 1 pick, also ran for 36 yards and another touchdown on the ground. Let's take a quick look at the National Arena League standings here as we are in the second game of the season for both these teams, but it is quite a ways into the season now. The Omaha Beavs sit atop of the heap at 2-0 on the year. They are followed by the Sioux City Bandits at 1-0. Carolina Cobras are in third at 2-1, that only loss coming to the Beef. Colorado Spartans are in fourth at 0-1. Oklahoma Flying Aces at fifth at 0-1. And Idaho Horsemen 0-2 round out the standings in sixth. Go off for your national anthem here inside the Tyson Event Center in Sioux City, Iowa. When we return, we'll keep it rolling as we are getting ready for National Arena League football action.
Ladies and gentlemen, please take off your hats and prepare for the singing of tonight's national anthem, performed by Sing for Joy, directed by Brian Cook.
Welcome back in here for more National Arena League action. We had our national anthem as well as a special presentation from New Breed. Should have mentioned this at the top of the broadcast as well, but it is Winnebago Community Night here in Sioux City. One of the biggest nights of the year for the Bandits. Proud supporter of the Winnebago community in the area. It's a big night for them. It's a special night to them, and very good show of respect from the people in the stands and the Bandits themselves for the Winnebago community. We went over the roster today for the Sioux City Bandits already. Let's take a look at the active roster for the visiting Oklahoma Flying Aces. Starting forward with them will be number 0, Arnell Anderson, 5'11", 210 pounds out of McKendree. Also number 1, Rashad Ridley, the wide receiver out of South Dakota School of Mines. Number 2, Hassan Muhammad Rogers, 5'11", out of Illinois State University. Number 4, Lakeith Murray, the 6'1", 193-pounder out of Marshall University. Jeremy Reynolds wears number 5 today, 6'2", 180 pounds out of Arizona Western. Thomas Bingham, number 6, 5'8", 175 out of the University of Tulsa, a receiver who had a good game in week 1 against these Bandits. The Bear and Mallory, 6'4", 203 pounds at the University of South Florida, had an interception week 1 out of his defensive back spot. This is where the names start to change, some new names and new places. C.J. French Love, 6'4", 230 pounds of Arizona State, saw him lining up at wide receiver in pregame routines. He's wearing the number 12 today. And the guy who was lining up at quarterback in those pregame warmups was Fred Payton Jr., number 13, 6'2", 210 pounds out of Mercer University. Number 15 for them, number 6'1", 217 pounds, all out of the University of Arizona, is Darian Clark. Number 17 is Corey Tucker out of Mid-American Nazarene. He's 6'2", 205. Austin Jones wears number 18 today out of Arkansas Baptist, 6'4", 235 pounds. Lionel Wiggins wears 43, 6'3", 260 out of San Jose State. Trey Small is out of North Carolina A&T, wears number 44 today, 6'2", 257. Number 58, Rob Powell Depp, 6'3", 315 pounder out of the University of South Alabama. Dante Ogburn, number 64, 6'2", 311 pounds out of Lane College. Benjamin Hughes, number 71, 6'2", 293 out of Oklahoma State. Gene Tappy is wearing number 75, 6'4", 306 out of Franklin Pierce. And Dominic Logan, 77, 6'6", 6 tall, 320 pound lineman out of Morgan State University. Name I skipped over by accident there is number 14. That's going to be Torrance Carr-Young, back to his natural position of wide receiver, we presume, this week. Played very well in week 1 against Bandits, out of position at the quarterback spot. Threw for over 100 yards and 3 touchdowns, did have an interception as well. So get some keys for both these teams to victory in this one. Starting with Sioux City, it's a 2-for-1. They don't want to overlook Oklahoma. The Flying Aces are a completely different team this week than they were in their last meeting in terms of some roster spots and as well as terms of overall preparedness. They had only 3 practices before their first game back in week 1 on March 15th. They've had a few weeks of practices now and hopefully have a lot more time under their belt to gel as a unit. Also, the Bandits are going to want to establish a passing attack today. Sioux City was held just 47 yards through the air last week, their fewest in a game since March of 2016. Both games coincidentally ended in wins for the Bandits, but it's not how Sioux City wants to run their offense. They can't be one-dimensional if they want to move to 2-0 and stay on pace with their rivals, the Beef, at the top of the National Arena League. For Oklahoma, your big key today to victory for the Flying Aces is going to be clean up those mental mistakes. Flying Aces were penalized 8 times for 55 yards in week 1, had numerous other miscues that led to bad possessions. A lot of that can be chalked up to their shortened training camp, but Oklahoma needs to prove that today that it is just a fluke and was just a lack of preparedness, and now that they are ready and gelling, they can play a clean game, especially if they want to win in this one. A couple key players I'm looking at for the Bandits today. First of all, it's going to be the quarterback position. Tyler Lonstein's going to get the start, but we might see a bit of Josh Hollins as well. Neither of them played in week 1, but we do have their preseason game stats. Lonstein went 5 for 8, 84 yards and 2 touchdowns, while Hollins went 5 for 11 for 50 yards and 1 touchdown. Hollins also had 2 carries for 9 yards, while Lonstein had 1 carry for 14. Another player is going to be an X-Factor player today. Brandon Shepard making his return after not playing in week 1. And it's a big get back for the these Sioux City Bandits. In 3 seasons with the Bandits for Brandon Shepard, he has 70 catches over 33 games for 33 touchdowns. He is averaging a receiving touchdown a game, and almost half the time he catches it, it ends up in 6. He is the definition of a big play threat. He's someone to keep an eye on today on the offensive side of the ball. Defensively, I'm looking at Braden Mintz. 9 tackles last week, 1.5 for a loss, also had a sack. As we mentioned, he's a Swiss Army knife. He also handling the kicking duties today, played a little running back last week. He really can do it all for this Bandits team. X-Factor today is going to be Zach Slugger on that defensive side of the ball. His first game for the Bandits, did not play in week one, did not play in their preseason games. The first week he's on the active roster. Look at his Bandits career, though. He had 375 tackles over his tenure, 33 tackles for loss, 15 pass deflections, six forced fumbles, and seven fumble recoveries. Also has a pick six. Coincidentally, against the Oklahoma Flying Aces back in 2019, one of two defensive touchdowns he scored in that game, as he's hoping for another show of force in this one. Looks like we are ready for kickoff here. Oklahoma will be kicking off, back deep to return. The franchise, Fred Bruno, and the new guy, Landon Freeman. A long-tenured man that they call the franchise, and a guy playing his first game for the Bandits. Interesting that those two are back there deep to return. Kicking off for Oklahoma here will be Jeremy Reynolds. Reynolds, the 6'2", 180-pounder out of Arizona Western. They're ready to go here from Sioux City, Iowa, the Tyson Event Center on Winnebago Community Night. Reynolds marches off his steps. Puts a boot through it. High end over end kick. Drifting back is Freeman. He's going to let it bounce off the boards and pick it up. Now he's going to have to bring it out of the end zone. He did return kicks at the University of Sioux Falls. Gets out to about the 10. Breaks off some tackles. Now he's up along the boards. He's going to go out of play. Let's talk about Landon Freeman here. Since we're already bringing up his name early on, his career at the University of Sioux Falls, over two seasons for Sioux Falls, he had 204 carries for 1,502 yards, 7.4 yards per carry, 18 total touchdowns with a long of 75. He also caught 21 passes for 227 yards, just under 11 yards per reception. Also, as I mentioned, return kicks at the University of Sioux Falls. As we see our first glimpse of him returning a kick here in a Sioux City Bandits uniform. Play clock already under 20 seconds here. Lonstein still hasn't stopped his conversation with Coach Jensen. Eight seconds to go as they break the huddle. It's going to be a power formation here. Two running backs behind. Braden Mines, the fullback. 3 seconds on the play clock. Lonstein fakes the handoff here. First play of the game. He's looking deep for Sammy Epps. He's got a man open towards the end zone. Sammy Epps tries to get it and bounces off the shoulder pads of Epps and falls incomplete. It was a little bit behind him, but it's a pass that Epps is going to want to have back almost with the big shot. First play of the game. Sammy Epps was covered by hopes and dreams heading into the end zone. Unfortunately, not able to bring it in for the Bandits. We'll see what Scott Jensen, the offensive coordinator, he's taken off the pads this week. Got his 200th career passing touchdown, stepped back in at quarterback in week one. And he returns to the headset. See what he draws up here on play two. Third and 10. A lot more play clock, a lot more time on the play clock here. So the Bandits have time to survey the defense. Epps, still the wide receiver on the line of scrimmage. Same formation, split backfield with Freeman and Prohaska. Handoff Prohaska, left side. He's got a couple lead blockers. No, that was Freeman. Check that. Gain of a couple yards. First handoff to Landon Freeman in his Sioux City Bandits debut. Gains 2 yards, brings up third and 8. Still thinking about that opening play. You know, that's one the Bandits want to have back. Two longtime head coaches here, Irv Strobien for the Bandits, Richard Davis for the Oklahoma Flying Aces. Two guys that know each other very well as well. Both running backs split out of the backfield now as Lonstein takes a three-step drop, looking over the middle. He has some blocks. Now he's forced to roll out to his right, still keeping his eyes downfield. He's going to be wrapped up in the backfield. That is the definition of a coverage sack for Oklahoma. It's a big play there to bring up fourth down. Looked like Langford was in there for the tackle. And the Bandits are going to go for a field goal attempt here from their own end zone. We'll see what kind of leg Braden Mintz has. Low snap, able to get it up is Lonstein. This one is drifting towards the stands, and it will be a souvenir for a fan in the first couple rows. It's a rush for it, and a young fan gets it, gets to take that one home. First possession does not end the way the Bandits want it to. Three and out, had an opportunity to deep ball in the first play of the game, unfortunately did not go their way. Ball gets placed at the 20-yard line after going out of play, so it'll be first and 10 from their own 20 for the Flying Aces. Might see some different names on the back of jerseys here than the ones we call out. Due to the quick turnaround and everything that Oklahoma had to go through very late in the preseason, weren't able to get the nameplates changed. But Fred Payton Jr. in there at quarterback. Empty set for him. Two receivers go in motion. High snap. Payton gets it. Rolls out to his right. Trying to get away. He's going to take off down the right side. He's going to be hit hard by Braden Mainz. And there's going to be a flag late on the play. I think they're going to get Mainz for unnecessary roughness, maybe. Officials conferring here. It's not the start the Bandits wanted of this one. Going 3-and-out on your first offensive drive, and Braden Mainz, your starting linebacker, getting a flag thrown on him right away. And the referees are going to pick up that laundry. So there will be no flange zone penalty flag here on the opening drive for the Oklahoma Flying Aces. Gain of a couple, though, on that play. Good play by Payton to scramble out the right side, sneak out the back door, and get a couple yards. See what they have here. Second down and about seven. Long six, short seven. Flag is going to fly. We're going to get a false start against Oklahoma. That's one of those mental mistakes they can't afford to make. Eight penalties against them in week one cost them 55 total yards. And now a false start's going to back them up behind the original line of scrimmage. The penalty flag is brought to you by Flanzone. Shotgun here, empty set again for Payton. High snap, snags with his right hand, going down left side, has Rashad Ridley for a first down and a little bit more. So a second and long doesn't matter. Shotgun formation here, one running back in, it's Bingham. On the left side of his quarterback, Payton. Two receivers go in motion. Payton takes a snap, chest high, looks quickly right side, but maybe a miscommunication there. Nobody was expecting a screen. Payton tries taking off. Don't know if that was by design, judging from the dismay of the coach for Oklahoma, Richard Davis. It was not by design that Fred Payton had to tuck that one and scramble for a yard. Payton was looking quick right side for a screen. Nobody was there waiting for it. Brings up second and down. Oklahoma still knocking on the door looking for their first score of the game. Second and nine here. Payton in the shotgun. Bingham on his right. Ridley goes in motion. Fakes the handoff, does Payton. Now rolls out to his right, bootleg, throws it over the middle. It's caught near the first down line, spins off a tackler. Now he's fighting towards the end zone. Is he down before the end zone line? They're going to say, no, he got over the goal line. That's the first touchdown of the game for the Oklahoma Flying Aces, and they take the lead here early on in this one. C.J. French Love, the big wide receiver, getting into the end zone there for the first six of the game and puts the Bandits behind the eight ball. Looks like the officials are going to review that one. Make sure everything was good. That spin up near the boards. If he was pushed into the boards off of that spin, he's out of bounds. So I understand why they're taking the time to look at this one. As it stands, Fred Payton Jr., his first start at quarterback for Oklahoma, is 2 for 2 with 30 yards and a touchdown. He also has all their rushing yards on 2 carries for 5 yards. And it's offense, not much to speak about. 0 for 1 for quarterback Tyler Lonstein on the deep ball. That was in and out of the hands of Sammy Epps. And Landon Freeman is the only carry, 1 rush for 2 yards. Monstein was also sacked on the first drive. Go some fan engagement here inside the Tyson Event Center while we wait for the official ruling to come back from the replay. This is not the start the Sioux City Bandits wanted. The exact opposite of getting out of the gates quickly, that's for sure. Three and out on your opening drive on offense and potentially down six already on defense. We're still at 8:55 to go in the first quarter of play. Officials have come out of the tunnel, so we will get an official word on the replay here. Got to assume they'll talk to Coach Strobien first.
After review, the ball field was reversed. The defense halt on the half-yard line of the defense. On the first goal, ball on the half-yard line.
So there was no contact with the boards off of the spin from CJ French Love. But his knee was down at the half-yard line. So now the Bandits get a chance at a goal line stand here to try to keep Oklahoma off the boards. We reset to 0-0 in this ballgame. Take that touchdown off the stat sheet for French Love and Peyton. Take down on the field for the Bandits right now. Aussie Tapua, Randall Blash, and Devin Groenhagen are the three down linemen. Mine's the linebacker. Your defensive backs, Justin Gilbert, Xavier Spann, Antonio Pierce, and Carlton Watkins. Mine's signaling he's blitzing, so he's coming after. Empty set here. Potentially a... Oh, there's a motion and then a play made at the line. Handoff up the middle, off the motion. It looks like the ball comes out, judging from this scramble here. Hard to tell from my angle. We'll see who recovered this one. Coach Loban thinks it belongs to the Bandits. Whistle's going to blow. No referee ruling yet. Now they put the arms up. That's a touchdown for Oklahoma. Good design run there. It was Lionel Wiggins. 6'3", 260-pounder out of San Jose State who came in motion and took that one up the gut with a lead blocker. Jeremy Reynolds in to kick now, the extra point. It's 6-0 Oklahoma. Just delayed the score by about a minute there. Reynolds to kick, hold is down, kick is up, and through the uprights, good. 7-0 Oklahoma leads here early on in quarter number one, 7:39 to go. After a three and out from the Bandits on their opening drive, and then a sustained drive by Oklahoma, ending in six. Fred Payton went 2 for 2 for 29 yards on that drive, one catch of 15 yards by Rashad Ridley, and one catch of 14 yards by CJ French Love. Payton also had two carries for 5 yards on that drive, and Lionel Wiggins with the 1 yard touchdown run puts the cap on that one. See what the Bandits offense comes out and does here on their second drive of the game. That is pending the kickoff. Crazy things have happened on kickoffs. No matter what level you play at. Fred Bruno had a touchdown return in week one against this Oklahoma Flying Aces team. No guarantee we see the Bandits offense on this next play, even though it is likely. Reynolds has the tee down. I'm just waiting for the ball. Coach Strobien still talking to a couple officials here. Your officials in this game are going to be Randy Hagendorn, Lance Ploger, John Garrow, Greg Jennis, and Monty Tilgner. Hagendorn is your white hat, your head referee for this crew. He's back in the end zone right now with Freeman and Bruno. Reynolds gets the ball, finally gets it teed up. with his guys, checks with the referee, everybody's set. Starts his run up, we're ready to get back going. Low driven kick this time, going towards Freeman, was gonna go out of play over the end zone. Bandits are gonna start first and 10 at their own 20 after the ball goes out of play. We'll see what Lahnstein and his offensive coordinator, Scott Jensen, can draw up here for drive number two. I see Brandon Shepard out on the field, maybe going more of a traditional offensive setup that we've seen in the past from the Bandits, and that's what they're doing. Lahnstein's going to go under center with Prohaska, the deep back, but there are going to be three receivers on the field. Epps on the line of scrimmage, Shepard and Bruno going in motion. Handoff up the gut to Prohaska, cuts it out left side, breaks through one tackler, but is going to be wrapped up by LeBaron Mallory. Pushed up along the boards. Gain of a couple there for Prohaska. Brings up second and eight. Prohaska able to break off that shoestring tackle in the backfield. Could have been a gain of nothing or even a loss. Now we're going to go shotgun for Sioux City. Epps on the line still. Bruno and Shepard in motion. Prohaska on the left hip pocket of his quarterback, Lahnstein. Chest high snap. Fires quick left side. Fred Bruno takes a couple stutter steps trying to get around the defender. Gets past the midfield line. Going to bring up third down here. About four to go before they're at that first down marker for Sioux City. Lahnstein in the shotgun again. Bruno and Shepard going to go in motion. Flip sides, though, for Epps. He's been lining up on the right side of the formation. Now he's on the left. Belt high snap, looking right side. A little swing pass out to Prohaska. He's got the first down and more. Eventually brought down near the 15-yard line, but a big play there to get a fresh set of downs for the Sioux City Bandits. Prohaska off the right side, trucking his own blocker there a little bit as he knocked Fred Bruno to the ground. So there's a lot of open space for Prohaska, too, if he was able to get around. Bruno is starting to engage in a block there. Lahnstein going under center. Prohaska the deep back, Shepard and Bruno going to go in motion. Bruno wraps around, both of them right side, fakes the pitch out. It looked like Lahnstein was expecting a pitch to the right to Prohaska. He was going back left, and Lahnstein forced to scramble out, and he's going to lose a couple yards. Miscommunication there between quarterback and running back. Lahnstein thought Prohaska was going power side with the motion of Shepard and Bruno. And from his conversation with Jensen, maybe the play call was to go counter. Get the defense moving one way, send Prohaska out the back door. Didn't work out that way, so it's going to bring up second and 11. Ball on the 16-yard line for the Bandits. Need to get to the five for a first down. Bruno's going to wrap around again. Shepard in motion as well. Chest high snap, looking left side. Now back over the middle is Lahnstein. A couple pump fakes. Now looking for Sammy Epps off the fingertips. That one would have been a tough catch to make. Couple of different pump fakes there from Lahnstein, trying to find a man open. It's been good coverage early on here, outside of the first play of the game for Oklahoma. You know, that was maybe part of the gameplay for the Bandits. They came out in that power set early on. Mindset of fullback, little wing power behind him with two running backs. Play action, go deep downfield to Sammy Epps, caught in the defense, sleeping out of the first gate. It's changed ever since. Epps and Bruno going to go in motion. Shepard on the line. Bruno wraps around. Lahnstein takes the snap, looking over the middle. He's forced to roll out to his left. He's under some pressure. Now gets past the original line of scrimmage, but he's brought down. Going to be fourth and about nine, maybe fourth and eight on the scramble. Lahnstein couldn't find anyone open. Bring up fourth down here for Sioux City. They're going to go for a kick. Mainz to kick. About a 28-yarder here. End zone's about 8 yards deep. Lahnstein with the hold. Mainz kick up and kick good. First 3 points of the game for the Bandits off of a Braden Mainz field goal. And that ball is actually caught up in the net. Gonna need another ball to get that ball out. But Bandits are on the board. 7-3 here with 3:41 to go in quarter number one. They respond not in the way they wanted to, but still points on the board for Sioux City. Looking at that drive. Lahnstein's stats now, he's 2-for-4 with 13 yards and a long of 9. Does have a sack, has taken a sack in this game for negative 8 yards. Drew Prohaska has 2 yards rushing, Landon Freeman has 2 yards rushing, and Tyler Lahnstein has 1 yard rushing on 2 attempts. Running game hasn't been there early on here for the Bandits. Receiving-wise, Prohaska is the leading receiver, 1 catch for 9 yards. Bruno has the other catch for 4 yards. do our daily dice roll here inside the Tyson Event Center. Looks like that's the next fan engagement segment we got coming up here. 3:41 to go in quarter number one, 7-3. Sioux City trails Oklahoma. The Bandits line up here to kick. See Zach Slugger out there on kickoff. Easiest way to get a guy going back up to speed in the game is get him out there on kickoffs. Say it's the easiest way to get hit, but sometimes you got to get hit. You got to lay a hit out there. You got to feel the contact of the game to really be back on the football field. Mines to kick off. See Jakari Christian, Zach Slugger, Aussie Tapool back there. Josh Holland's the backup quarterback on kick coverage as well. Aaron Roundtree, Carlton Watkins. Goals landed Freeman. Back deep to return is Rashad Ridley. He's a dangerous return man for the Oklahoma Flying Aces. Had a couple big returns in week one against the Sioux City team. Set up some scores. Mines checks everybody. Starts his run up. Gets this one away. High end over end kick drifting towards the back of the end zone. It's brought in by Ridley. Deep in his own end zone. Brings it out past the goal line. Trying to get out right side. We got a flag down on the play. Ridley still looking for space. Eventually he's brought down by a gang of bandits around the 10-yard line. Flag is near the 20-yard line. Flags are brought to you by Flan Zone. See what the head official says. It's going to be a holding penalty against Oklahoma. Half the distance of the goal, so it's going to be first and 10 from inside their own 10. First and 10 from their own 5-yard line now for the Flying Aces. See what we have here from Fred Payton Jr. Lining up in the shotgun, Bingham on his right. See Ridley going to go in motion as is Zuri Davis. Snap, chest high, handoff Bingham left side. He's going to be met by a couple bandits at the line of scrimmage. He's trying to fight forward for a yard. He does get it. Carlton Watkins was there, as was Randall Blash. Big Randall Blash playing nose tackle tonight. Blash is a big man at that nose tackle spot. 6'1", 320 pounds out of the University of Sioux Falls. Whistle's going to blow. We're going to get a timeout here. Well, looks like the player maybe rolled an ankle getting back to the play for Oklahoma. Training staff out to check on him. Can't quite see the jersey number. It is an offensive lineman that's down for him. A couple fingers being pointed at Rashad Ridley, who Coach Loban of the Bandits deemed was standing too close to their huddle while they're trying to game plan. Referee's putting up a little bit of a striped wall between him and the huddle. An extended look here at this offensive lineman for Oklahoma. He's able to get up. He's walking off under his own power. Be a new piece on that offensive line for Oklahoma when they get back to action. We'll see if the Bandits try to focus on that side right away. Pal Depp, Tapia, and Logan are the three linemen right now. Dominic Logan, Tapia number 75, and Pal Depp's 58, the center. Shotgun formation here for Fred Payton Jr. Sends his men to the line. Low snap, a little bit away from him, looking downfield. Antonio Pierce tries to turn around on it, but it's caught by Zuri Davis. Davis gets around Pierce near the 15-yard line, eventually swung down by the defensive back, but not before a big gain for Oklahoma. Going from their own 5-yard line all the way down to about the 12-yard line of the Bandits. About 33 yards on that play. That's a big one for Oklahoma. Smart play by Peyton there. Smart throw by the quarterback. Davis was going stride for stride with Pierce down the left side. Threw a back shoulder ball. Davis caught up to it first. Was able to stop his momentum. Let Pierce go by him. Pierce eventually was able to make the tackle. First and 10 now for Oklahoma from the 12. Peyton takes the snap. Looking quick right side. Gets it out to his receiver. Braden Mintz is there trying to get a tackle brought down eventually. Mintz was in there, as was Watkins. Watkins has the ball, and he's looked like he was trying to claim he got it before the tackle was made. Justin Gilbert in there as well. Now C.J. French Love, wide receiver on that one. Looked like a play that they tried to run in the last possession that was designed, but there was no receiver there waiting for the screen. This time there was, and it gets him a few yards. About seven there. It's going to bring up second and 3. Second and 3 from the Bandits 5-yard line. They're in the red zone, are the Flying Aces. Peyton. Motion. They both go left side. Looking quickly back corner of the end zone. French Love can't high point the ball. Justin Gilbert was there in coverage. Almost ended up in the lap of a couple Bandits fans here on the side of the end zone. Another souvenir for the Sioux City faithful. Brings up a tough third down here. Crucial third down for this Bandits defense, as well as this Flying Aces offense. We're under 20 seconds to go now in this first quarter of play. The play clock is off. And with no move to get into a huddle here for the Flying Aces, maybe they're just drawing something up for the first play of quarter number 2, and Coach Loban knows it. He's calling his defense over. That is going to do it for the first quarter of play here from Sioux City. Defensive stalemate so far, 7-3. Oklahoma leads over the Sioux City Bandits. Take a look at your first quarter stats here. Starting with the Oklahoma Flying Aces, they are on offense. Fred Payton Jr., 4-for-5 for 68 yards in that first quarter of play. He's also the leading rusher at 2 carries for 5 yards. C.J. French Love has the most catches, 2 catches for 21 yards. Zuri Davis has the most yards, a 32-yarder in that first quarter of play. Lionel Wiggins is the lone touchdown of this game so far, a 1-yard run for him. His only play on offense so far. Flipping sides of the field here. Still a big third down coming for Oklahoma. For Sioux City as well defensively, but Oklahoma has the ball in their hands. Trying to get on that scoreboard. Once again, as they lead 7-3. Fresh 15 on the clock as we start the second quarter of action here in the National Arena League. Oklahoma was huddled up near where the original spot was, so they got to chug about 40 yards before they can even get to the new spot. Power formation here. It's an offset back. He's going to act as a lead blocker potentially. This is the same play they ran earlier on to score. They're going to fake it this time. They'll look for a pass towards Carl Young. Is there broken up? Great play by Carlton. Watkins got a hand in there. I believe Antonio Pierce was there as well. He was. Great play by the Bandits defense. Working off of what worked earlier, going play action off of it. Smart call by Richard Davis, the head coach. Crucial fourth down here for Oklahoma. They don't want to give the Bandits the ball back in which great territory for Oklahoma. They don't want to leave this thing scoreless, but they also want to get 6 out of it, and we're going to get a timeout on the field. Timeout taken by Oklahoma. I'm going to redraw this one up, check it over again. It's a big play for both teams. Oklahoma could go up 14-3 here early on in the first half of play. And Sioux City could stop the Oklahoma Flying Ace momentum that they've seemed to build on these opening couple drives. You see the kicker, Jeremy Reynolds, out there talking to an official. Wonder if Oklahoma's going to change their tune and try to kick this. Reynolds is out there as they break the huddles, and it looks like that's exactly what Oklahoma's going to try to do. Try to get three on the board, go back up seven. It would remain a one-score game. Bandits might not be too torn up to be only down one score if this does go in. It's the Bandits team that likes to get after these special teamers. Try to block this one. Gronhagen, Blash, Mainz, and Tapua are going to be the down linemen. Reynolds to kick, Zuri Davis to hold. Getting another player on special teams here. Rashad Ridley is going to be the snapper. Short time on the play clock. Snap is good. Hold is down. Kick from Reynolds is up. Off the right upright. It's going to be bobbled up in the air. It's active. It drops down near the goal line. There's a scramble for it in the end zone. And Oklahoma's going to get on top of it in the end zone. A flag is going to come down as well, though. Oklahoma signaling touchdown. The officials are saying, hold your breath. We got to figure out what this flag's about first. That's the importance of these rebound nets, something that Sioux City is definitely not used to. First year in the National Arena League, have not had these rebound nets before. A couple players exchanging words now. Coach Strobing sending his troops back to the bench. I see Sioux City's offense taking the field, so I feel like they're going to wipe those no points on the board. They're going to say no touchdown. We'll see what the flag's about. Dominic Logan still signaling touchdown for Oklahoma. His hands have not left the touchdown position. We'll get the official ruling here from the head official. That's another new rule here in the NAL. New for both these teams. It's a kick-catch interference off of the rebound. So Oklahoma interfered with the potential kick catch as Mainz, I believe, was the one going up trying to bring it down.
Then I pulled it anyway.
And now the play is under review. Calamity with the rebound nets here. First time we've seen something like this come into play for Sioux City. Looks like the offense is on the field. We're going to see a new quarterback as Josh Hollins is out there. Tyler Lawnstein has played the first two drives. Similar to what we saw in the preseason game for Sioux City. Two quarterback setup. During a break in the action, I see man of the people and all-around Swiss Army knife, Braden Mainz, also well-known good guy, interact with some fans there, field side. Braden Mainz used to be an instructor at my brother's school, recently took a new job to go to his alma mater, so congratulations to him on that, just to go back to his hometown and teach at the high school level. I know my brother's not happy to see him go, but happy for him. It'll be first and 10 Bandits here. All the rulings on the field will stand as called, so the penalty will be marched off. First and 10 from the 14-yard line for Sioux City after the 10-yard penalty. Holland's going to go under center. Bruno and Shepard in motion. A little quick pitch out to Prohaska, left side. Flags are going to fly. He's going to be brought down at the line of scrimmage. Prohaska gets back to the line of scrimmage at best, but a couple flags from different areas. Land zone penalty flag. Number zero. It's an illegal defense against Oklahoma. Called it against Arnell Anderson, I believe. So it's going to be first and 10 here for Sioux City, or first and 5, excuse me, for Sioux City from the 19-yard line. Hollins takes a snap, handoff for Hask up the middle, gets some blocks, jumps through a hole and finds his way to the line to gain, maybe gets another yard past it. He's eventually driven back. Josh Hollins doesn't like it. No flags fly. Prohaska still lets him know he got enough for the first, and it is. First and 10 from the 25-yard line for Sioux City here after some tough running from Drew Prohaska before he was driven back by about 5 or 6 Oklahoma Flying Aces. Hollins under center again. Prohaska back deep. Crisscross behind him. Hollins bobbles the snap. He's just going to fall back down on top of it, lose a couple yards, but saves possession. Brings up second about 13 here for Sioux City. Want to get at least half of that back, make it third and manageable. Hollins gets the play call from his offensive coordinator, Scott Jensen, and marches into the huddle, barks some orders to his men. Hollins says he's going to go under center again. Stephen Fluker, the center. Sterling Clark, the right guard. Omar Roberts, the left guard. Prohaska, the deep back. Bruno's lining up on the line of scrimmage. A couple men go in motion. Hollins takes the snap. A little bootleg, play action. Now goes back to his left, looking over the middle field. Has Brandon Shepard. He's tackled, but it's going to be a first down for Brandon Shepard. His first catch of the season for the Sioux City Bandits in National Arena League play. Gets a fresh set of downs. First and 10 from the 14-yard line. Big first down there for the Bandits. Josh Hollins trying to get this offense rolling. They've been held to 3 points so far here in early in the second quarter of play. 11:45 and counting to go. Hollins in the shotgun, one of the first times. Prohaska on his right, take the snap, design quarterback run. He's going to go off the right side. He has some space, trying to get along the board. Stiff arm as well. He's going to get inside the 5. New set of downs. It's going to be goal to go. The Bandits are in the red zone thanks to the legs of Josh Hollins.
Hollins on the carry. That's good for a Sioux City Bandits.
I'm watching Devin Groenhagen and Braden Mintz run out to the huddle right now. I feel like we're going to get a power formation. No lineman checked out, so Groenhagen's going to join Roberts, Clark, and Fluker. This is a power formation. Similar to the formation we saw in the first play of the game, but Mintz is now a deep back with Groenhagen as more of a fullback. Hollins, handoff, Prohaska, right side, flag's going to fly. Prohaska trying to get to the end zone. He's going to be grabbed high around the shoulders and whipped down. Gained a couple yards, but we have a flan zone penalty flag. See who this is against here. Brandon Shepard was tapping his chest while looking at head coach Irv Strobeen. We'll see if it is against him or if he was signaling for something else. Oh, they're both on the defense. Two illegal defense penalties against Oklahoma. Still trying to work out the miscues here. First down from about the 2-yard line now, maybe 3. Short 3 or a long 2, either way you cut it. Holland's going to go under center, still power formation. Groenhagen the fullback, split backfield, Mintz and Prohaska. Hollins, handoff up the middle to Mintz. He puts the shoulder down, trying to truck through. He stood up, pushed backwards, and the whistles are going to blow. They're going to give him a yard, if anything, there. A few words being exchanged. Mintz excusing himself from that conversation. Doesn't want to get a flag thrown on him. Was a little bit of shoving after the play, but both players cordial, leaving the conversation at least. Mintz was tangled up with Hassan Muhammad Rogers. Another play for a power formation. Second and goal from about the 1. Hollins, handoff. Prohaska trying to get up the middle. Spins away from one tackle. Now trying to push through another. Hollins looked like he was running up trying to push from behind, but he stopped at the line of scrimmage. It's a big defensive stand so far for Oklahoma. I actually say he lost a yard. So third and goal from the 2 now. Third and goal from the 2-yard line. Sticking in that power formation is Sioux City. Hollins under center. Mindset for Prohaska, the deep backfield. Still got to keep an eye on Brandon Shepard, the wide receiver split out wide to the right. Hollins bobbles the snap. They're just going to push him from behind. Groenhagen pushed him in. Hollins is going to get in there for six after the bobbled snap. Josh Hollins puts the Bandits on the board with their first touchdown of the game, and they're up 9-7 with 9:13 and counting to go in the second quarter of play, pending this extra point. Hollins leading the big touchdown drive there for Sioux City. Mainz in for the extra point. Lonstein's going to be the holder. Low snap, bobbled, but Lonstein gets it. Kick up, kick good from Braden Mainz. Makes it 10-7 here inside the Tyson Event Center. The Bandits lead by three with 8:44 to go in quarter number two. The Oklahoma offense will look to answer when they get the ball back. Got t-shirt toss going here. One of my favorite times of the game. Anything to get the fans some more souvenirs, some more merchandise. So we're going to get some fan engagement as well during this break in the action. Under a media timeout here, 8:44 to go in quarter number two. During this break in the action, let's give you a stat update. We haven't really talked about the defense so far, so let's look at the defensive stats for both these teams. We'll start with the Flying Aces. They were just on the defensive side of the ball. Caron Bolden, 3 tackles, 1 sack, 2 TFLs is leading the team in tackles right now. LeBaron Mallory has 3 tackles. Hassan Muhammad, Arnell Anderson, Darian Clark, Leon Smalls each have 2 apiece. For the Bandits, Braden Mainz, the leading tackler, with 3 on the game. Justin Gilbert has 2. Antonio Pierce, Xavier Spann, Randall Blash, Devin Groenhagen, Carlton Watkins, Josh Hollins, Ossie Tapua, and Zach Slugger all have 1. Carlton Watkins also has that crucial pass breakup on the last offensive drive for the Oklahoma Flying Aces. That broke up what would have been a touchdown catch. Could be a completely different game right now if that goes the other way. Now the momentum is swinging the pendulum to the side of the Bandits. They lead by 3. 8:44 to go in quarter number 2. Mainz to kick off. He's marching out his steps. Rashad Ridley back deep to return for Oklahoma. Mainz checks with his crew, now runs forward, puts a boot through it. Low driven kick is going to bounce it about the 5. High bounce into the arms of Ridley just inside the goal line. Trying to find some space, runs into one of his. Tries to get away again and does. Lonstein's there for a tackle as well as Sammy Epps. Rashad Ridley tried making something out of nothing there and almost did, but it's going to be 1st and 10 from their own 11-yard line. Could have been worse if you don't have a guy like Ridley back there. They're going to say he got to the 12 here. So 1st and 10 from their own 12. Fred Payton Jr. has had a good day so far from the quarterback spot. 4 for 6 through the air for 68 yards. He's also the leading rusher at 5 yards on the ground. Came up short on their last drive. Oklahoma trying to get back in the lead here. They trail 10-7 after that touchdown by the Bandits. 2 receivers go out wide to the right in motion, looping around. Quick pass out to Zeri Davis. A little bit behind him. He's pushed up along the boards. Whistle's going to blow. They're going to credit Carlton Watkins with that tackle there as he shoved him along the boards. You can contact the boards, but if you're pushed into them, it's out. Zeri Davis kept running there. That is why. Gain, check that, loss of 0.5 yard. As a pass, Drew Davis behind the line of scrimmage. Shotgun formation here again for Payton. Takes the snap. Flag is going to fly, and the pass is going to be out of reach of Thomas Bingham. Bounce into the stands as a souvenir for a fan. See who this flag is on. Penalty flags are brought to you by Flanzone. So guards can declare as receivers, and only one can declare per play, however. And both guards, I guess, declared to the officials. That'll be a penalty. Does not back them up as it was declined by the Bandits to bring up third down and 11.
It's third down.
It's a short 11. It's basically third and 10 and a half. Empty set here for Peyton. Only one receiver going to go in motion. I checked that. Two receivers. I didn't see Torrance Carr-Young hiding along the boards. Peyton forced to step on the pocket. Slips down just past the original line of scrimmage. Gain of a couple there. Braden Mintz makes sure he's down by contact. Fred Peyton had a little bit of space. Would have had to get around Mintz if he was going to do anything more with it. Makes it fourth and nine. Going to bring in the kicker here for Oklahoma. Fred Bruno is going to go back deep. Looks like Justin Gilbert back deep as well. For those who don't remember, Justin Gilbert was a great kick returner back at Oklahoma State. Very shifty in the open field. We'll see either him or Bruno come up with it, or the kicker can send this one through the uprights. Flag is going to fly. We're going to get a delay of game. Took too long getting set up for Oklahoma. Already a long kick. Back him up a little more. See if Jeremy Reynolds can hit from far out here. It's going to be from their own 7-yard line there, so about maybe six. It'll be about the 7-yard line. Ridley the snap. Davis to hold. Reynolds to kick. He's in his own end zone. Shadow of his own rebound nets. Snap is down. Kick from Reynolds is driven low and into the crowd, out of play. Another souvenir for a fan. It'll be first and 10 Bandits when they get back out there on the field. Josh Hollins led that touchdown drive on the last possession. He's going to go back out there again to get the start. Ball went out of play. About the 22, that's really going to mark it. First and 10 from the 22. First and 10 from the 22 for Hollins and company. Prohaska, the running back. Looks like Shepard and Bruno going to go in motion. Epps on the line of scrimmage. Hollins sends his men to the line. Chest high snap, pressure up the middle. Gets away from it for a moment, trying to get back to the line of scrimmage. Gets past it to the midfield stripe. Got to the 25, gain of three, gain of two. Gain of three they're going to give him. Brings up second and 7. Hollins turning something out of nothing. Hollins under center here. Takes the snap. Fakes the handoff, now goes deep downfield. Brandon Shepard covered by nobody. He gets in there for six. 34th career touchdown in his 34th career game. Brandon Shepard puts the Bandits back on the board again. They're up 16-7 over the Oklahoma Flying Aces here in Sioux City, Iowa. 4:57 to go, pending this extra point. Big play threat. No matter where he's lined up, Brandon Shepard gets six on the board there. Mintz to kick now, Launstein to hold. Snap is a little high, Launstein gets it down. Mintz up, Mintz good on the extra point. Makes it 17-7 now. Sioux City leads by 10. Another score makes it a 10-point lead for Sioux City. 4:57 to go. Taking a look at that last drive for the Bandits. Took only 59 seconds off the clock to go two plays for 28 yards and the touchdown pass to Brandon Shepard. That touchdown pass, 25 yards from court, is now led back-to-back touchdown drives. Get the Bandits offense rolling here. Mines back to kick now for Sioux City. Oklahoma still getting their kick return team on the field. We can presume that Rashad Ridley is going to be back there to return. He's going back there now. Mines getting it teed up here for the Bandits. Tyson Event Center starting to rock a little bit as the Bandits have taken a 10-point advantage. Mines checks with his men, now starts his run-up, boots through it, driven kick going to Ridley, bounces at about the three, bounces into the end zone and over the boards. It'll be first and 10 Oklahoma here. Ball bouncing in the field of play, going over the wall, ruled as a touchback. We'll start at the 5-yard line for Oklahoma. They've had both instances happen today. So if it flies out on the kickoff without touching the ground, it gets placed at the 20. But if it bounces in the field of play and then goes over the wall, it's placed at the 5. Either way, it still counts as a touchback, but it just depends on the field position to start. In this case, for Oklahoma. First and 10 from their own 5, Fred Payton Jr., the quarterback. Running back on his right, a couple men going to go in motion. Sends it to the line now, does Payton. Low snap, handoff left side. He's going to be wrapped up by Tapua. No, he's going to shake off the tackle from Tapua and get down for a gain of about 7. Asking to feed him the ball to Hassan Muhammad Rogers. Like a spoon in cereal, the universal sign for give me the rock. See if he gets it back here, second and about 3. Payton sends his men to the line. Snap, fakes the handoff. This one's going to be a read option. Devin Ronhagen reads it well, and he's going to be brought down in the backfield. The long arm of the law with a tackle for loss. Aaron Roundtree in there as well. Brings up 3rd and 4. Big third down here for the Bandits. Big third down for both teams. Oklahoma had momentum to start this one.
Tackle for loss.
Fallen by the wayside here of late. It's been all Bagan, all Bandits, 14 unanswered points for them, leads this game 17-7. Mike Payton Jr., shotgun snap, handoff to Hassan. Off the right side, he's going to get a fresh set of downs, and Moore is eventually going to be upended at the 21-yard line. A couple Bandits in there on the tackle, Groenhagen as well as Spann, but it's going to be a new set of downs for Oklahoma. Trying to establish that running game. A running game that before this drive did not have much, under 10 yards. About 9 yards total rushing almost through the entire first half before this drive. And now Hassan Muhammad is the leading rusher as well. With just 2 carries. Snap, chest high, quick pass out left side, it's going to be dropped. Watkins was going to be there to wrap up, but the catch was made, but it was in and out of the hands of the receiver. C.J. French Love. Brings up 2nd and 10 now for Oklahoma. Still just the little miscues are getting Oklahoma. Penalties at the worst times. Unhelpful drops. Had the play earlier where there was miscommunication, a potential screen pass that Payton had to run out of. Sends his man to the line. Takes the snap, out belt high, hand off to Hassan. Takes off on the left side. He's almost tripped up by Watkins, but able to get away and get a block. He's eventually going to be pushed up along the boards out of play. But turns what would have been a 2-yard loss into about an 8-yard gain. Hassan Muhammad Rogers.
Let your defense hear you, Bandit fans.
Keeps running like this, he's going to be a little more of a factor for this offense later on. Zach Slugger out there on the defensive line. He's with Groenhagen and Tapua. Keep an eye on him here. Shotgun formation. And the line sends him from Payton. Trying to fire left side, and was knocked away by, I believe, Slugger, if it didn't hit off the back of an offensive lineman for Oklahoma. And it was Slugger who got a paw on that one. Say his name and he appears. I believe in Zach Slugger. And with that, we're at our 1 minute warning. It'll be normal football timing rules for the rest of this first half of play. Bandits lead 17-7. 57 seconds to go in the second quarter. Look at some stats here for both these teams offensively. We'll start with the Bandits. Tyler Lonstein started this game at quarterback, went 2-for-4 for 13 yards, had a pass deep down the right sideline that was in and out of the hands of Sammy Epps. Would have been six, would have been a 45-yard touchdown first play of the game. Josh Hollins has stepped in the last two drives. He's 2-for-2 for 38 yards and a touchdown, 25 yards to Brandon Shepard, who is the leading receiver with two catches for 38 yards and that touchdown. Leading rusher, also Joshua Hollins. Four carries for 13 yards and a touchdown on the ground, long of 11. Prohaska has three carries for 8 yards. Landon Freeman, who we haven't seen since the opening drive, had one carry for 2 yards. Drew Prohaska also has a catch for 9 yards, and Fred Bruno has another catch for 4 yards. Looking at the Flying Aces, Fred Payton Jr. started out 4-for-5. He's been 1-for-5 since. He's 5-for-10 total, 67 yards through the air, and along a 32, no touchdowns yet. Hassan Muhammad has taken over the lead running spot. On this drive, he has three carries for 23 yards and a long of 10. 7.7 yards per carry on this drive right now for Muhammad. He has all their yards so far on this possession. Fred Payton Jr., second in rushing, four carries for 6 yards. Zuri Davis, the leading receiver, two catches for 31 yards. C.J. French Love has two carries for 21 yards. The lone touchdown of the game for Oklahoma, run by Lionel Wiggins off of a power formation out of some motion. Crucial fourth down here for both these teams. 57 seconds to go here in the second quarter of play. Tyson Event Center getting loud. Might have to get a little loud with them on the broadcast. Motion out to an empty set here for Fred Payton Jr. Looking left side, quick pass, a little high, near the line to gain. He's going to be stood up by a couple Bandits trying to bring him down. Eventually is. Judge on my side of the field is saying he's just a yard short. If that stands on the field, first and 10 from the Bandits from the 20-yard line, and that's where they're going to mark it. A yard short, great defensive stand. I know it's Braden Mintz and Zach Slugger were in there. Looks like Antonio Pierce as well. Looking at the replay right now on the big board here in Sioux City. Mintz got there first. Slugger was able to help push him back, as was Antonio Pierce. He got there second after Mintz. Great play from the Bandits defense. Brings up a fresh set of downs for them. First and 10, they take over after the turnover on downs. 50 seconds to go here in quarter number two. That's an eternity in the arena game. Especially with the timing rules after 1 minute to go in each half. Hollins under center, Prohaska the deep back. Handoff, Prohaska left side, cuts through a hole, gets a couple yards, stretches forward for at least an extra one. And give him two. That clock's ticking. 35 seconds to go in this second quarter of play. Sioux City wants to try to get a score here to end this first half. Oklahoma gets the ball back to start half number two. He'd love to go into the halftime break up 3 scores. Hollins, low snap, able to pick it up from his knees. Now forced to roll out to his right, getting some pressure. He almost slips down. Now he's eventually going to be brought down. There's a flag on the play as well. We'll see what it all is. If the sack stands, Hollins was brought down near his own 10-yard line. If the penalty is against Oklahoma, it'll move the ball in a good direction for Sioux City. The penalty is against Sioux City. You assume the Flying Aces would decline it. Still waiting on an official ruling here. 16 seconds to go currently on the scoreboard. The Bandits leading 17-7 in the first half of play. Thank you for joining me this evening here for National Arena League Football. I am Braden Butler. I always appreciate you joining us. Penalty goes against the defense for an illegal twist. It's going to give 5 yards to the Bandits. Timeout also taken by Sioux City to save some time on that play, on that game clock. 16 seconds to go. It was the first timeout of the half taken by Sioux City. They got two more to play with. It's going to Going to bring up about a second and three as well. So good field position for him for about the 23-yard line. Both teams back on the field after the timeout. Holland's going to go in the shotgun. Prohaska on his left hip pocket. Epson Shepherd going to be in motion. Fred Bruno going to be split out wide to the left. Holland takes the snap. Has some time looking downfield. Now he's going to scramble up the middle, try to get to the first down marker. He's going to be just short. Going to bring up third and short. The clock went off in Holland's head, said, get what I can. Call another timeout, get another play drawn up. Still time for maybe two plays for Sioux City here. That one took 7 seconds off the clock, so another 7 second play would leave them with still two, and they still have one timeout remaining. They bring up third and inches here in Sioux City when they get back out on the field. Holland's trying to lead a touchdown drive to end the first half of play. Sioux City leads 17-7 over Oklahoma. Want to go into that halftime break, potentially with a three-score lead, especially considering Oklahoma gets the ball to start half number two. Trying to get a little closer here, maybe even could have Braden Mines kick the extra point and go up 13. He's been 2-for-2 on PATs so far. He also has a field goal made in this one. But you'd rather have six than three. Hollins in the shotgun. Bruno wraps around him. Shepherd in motion as well. Snap never came. It's going to be a false start on the offense. Backs him up 5 yards. Penalty flags brought to you by Flanzone. Going to make it 3rd and 6 now from their own 24-yard line of the Bandits. Got 9 seconds to go 26 yards. There's about two plays left in this half no matter what, so we'll see what Hollins and the offense goes for. Empty set, Bruno and Epps going to be in motion. Prohaska and Shepherd lined up on the line of scrimmage. Whistle's going to blow. They're going to say delay a game. Back-to-back 5-yard penalties for the Bandits. Backs them up to their own 19-yard line. And you got 31 yards to go if you want six. Only 9 seconds to do it. Hollins breaks the huddle. He's in the shotgun with Prohaska on his left. Shepherd and Bruno, the receiver's in motion. Bruno wrapping around. Hollins takes the snap. Looking left side, dumps it off to Prohaska down the left sideline. He's got a lot of space. Now he goes over the boards, out of bounds. And that'll stop the clock at 3 seconds. No timeout needed, but this will be the last play of the half. Fresh set of downs for the Bandits as well, not that it matters. This will be first down from the 16-yard line of Sioux City. And Mind steps out there. It looks like they're going to kick. Tyler Lonstein's usually the holder, but it's Fred Bruno out here right now to hold. Keep an eye on that. Snap is good. Bruno gets the hold down. No trickery, but it's going to be blocked at the line. Ball is up, rotating near the boards, picked up by Hassan Muhammad. He's brought down. That's going to end the first half of play. 17-7, the Bandits lead by 10, heading into the halftime break here in the National Arena League. 10-point advantage for Sioux City, but a couple mistakes on that last drive, a couple costly penalties, potentially keeping points off the board for the Bandits. Now the stats for the first half of play. I as a team. The Oklahoma Flying Aces have 70 yards passing, 101 yards of total offense when you had their 31 on the ground, averaging 5.1 yards per play, 1 for 4 on third down, 0 for 1 on fourth down with 12.4 minutes of possession so far. Bandits got 15 minutes and 6 seconds of possession, 4.1 yards per play, 87 yards of total offense, 29 on the ground, 58 through the air. 8 first downs gotten for the Bandits and 5 so far for Oklahoma. It is Winnebago Community Night here inside the Tyson Event Center for Sioux City Bandits football. So we got a special presentation of that for you during halftime. At the conclusion, I'll be back and we'll talk more heading into the second half here. But enjoy this.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, it's Winnebago Community Day. Introducing the Winnebago
may have to help me out with this just a second. We're going to see how quick you are with music. I heard there's something going on today. It's Hunter's birthday. So maybe if the booth's out here, we can do some birthday music, and everybody can sing a happy birthday. How about that? And anybody else is having a birthday today, this is for you as well. So, on three, let's all sing. I don't know the music if you think everybody is. On one, two, three. Happy. Louder. Party here in the field. Hunter, yeah. All right, nice job. Round of applause for everybody for singing tonight. Thank you so much. Happy birthday, Hunter. All right, here we go. We're going to start here at the 20-yard line, the Nova Scarpa 20-yard line, for a chance to win a $500 gift certificate from Nova. You ready? All you got to do is put that hole right there. On your mark, whenever you're ready, get set, go. Oh, that was really good. That was one of the best. Can you get one more, I think? Can you get one more? Can you get one more? All right, come on. Here we go. Oh, one more. Here we go. Oh, Hunter, nice job. Big round of applause for Hunter tonight. And thank you, fly soon. And everybody else, thank you so much. All right.
Still at halftime here for the National Arena League. Sioux City Bandits football leading the Oklahoma Flying Aces 17-7 at our break. Big thank you to Winnebago Tribe, their Winnebago Community Night, for a special performance here at halftime. The Winnebago Dancers. Always entertaining. It was a great performance here to keep everybody entertained at halftime and also just to enjoy as someone myself. Also helped the old pipes a little bit. Didn't have to talk as much at halftime. That always helps. Get a little more water in me, should say, to say the least. Take a look at your first half stats. We looked at your team stats before we went to break. What? Let's look at your individual stats now. Tyler Lonstein started the game. He went 2 for 4 at quarterback for 13 yards. He was replaced by Joshua Holland. Hollins went 3 for 3 for 53 yards and a touchdown. During his time out there on the field, he's also the leading rusher at 5 carries for 15 yards and a rushing touchdown as well. Brandon Shepard, welcome back, Brandon. Missed week one, now is back here for the second game of the season. 2 catches for 38 yards and a touchdown, that one 25 yards from Joshua Hollins. Drew Prohaska had 2 catches for 24 yards as well, the long of 15. Right, Bruno, the only other reception in this game, 1 catch for 4 yards. Looking at the stats for Oklahoma on offense, Fred Payton Jr., 6 for 11 for 70 yards, long of 32. Hassan Muhammad has got the run game going there late in the second quarter. He had 3 carries for 23 yards and a long of 10. Fred Payton Jr. has 4 carries for 6 yards, 1 carry for 1 yard for Thomas Bingham and Lionel Wiggins. Wiggins got that carry for a touchdown as well. C.J. French-Love is the leading receiver right now in terms of catches with 3 catches for 24 yards. Zuri Davis, the leading receiver in yards, 2 catches for 31 yards. A long of 32 as well, so he did have that one screen pass that ended up being brought down behind the line of scrimmage. Defensive stats for both these teams. Looking at their leaders and tackles, Braden Mintz leading the Bandits right now with 5 tackles. Devin Groenhagen has 4 tackles, one of those for loss. Justin Gilbert has 3. Antonio Pierce, Carlton Watkins, Zach Slugger, and Ossie Tapua have 2 apiece. Watkins has a TFL and a pass breakup, as well as Zach Slugger has a pass breakup for the Bandits defense. Caron Bolden, leading tackler for Oklahoma, 4 tackles, 1 sack, 2 tackles for loss. LeBaron Mallory, Hassan Muhammad, Leon Smalls, and Darian Clark each have 3 apiece. Arnold Anderson has 2. Austin Jones, Lakeith Murray, Corey Tucker, Lionel Wiggins each have 1. Smalls also has a field goal block in this one, as a field goal attempt was blocked at the end of the first half for Sioux City by Oklahoma. Still got a couple minutes to go here in the half. Take a look at the drive chart for each of these teams. First drive of the game for the Bandits. was three and out, ended in a missed field goal. 3 minutes off the clock for them. Had that first play of the game, the deep ball dialed up to Sammy Epps. But it was in and out of the hands. Did not end up in a score and ended up in a turnover for Sioux City. The first drive of the game for Oklahoma ended in a touchdown. They went five plays, 30 yards, 3 minutes and 36 seconds. And that touchdown was off that one-yard run by Lionel Wiggins. Sioux City answered with a field goal on their next drive. Seven plays, 16 yards, three minutes, 50 seconds off the clock. And then that was followed up by the Oklahoma Flying Aces, who took the ball into the second quarter, ending their drive with a missed field goal, six plays for 40 yards. In that second quarter of play, first possession for the Bandits went 5 minutes and 46 seconds, seven plays for 46 yards and a touchdown. Oklahoma would respond with a three and out on their end, ending in a missed field goal, four plays for 4 yards. Second to last drive of the half for the Bandits ended in a touchdown. Two plays, 28 yards, capped off by that 25-yard touchdown. Pitch and catch from Joshua Hollins to Brandon Shepard. That lasts only 59 seconds. The Flying Aces then have a turnover on downs on their next drive, going seven plays for 25 yards, 4 minutes and 2 seconds off the clock. And the final 50 seconds of that first half ended with a blocked field goal for Sioux City. They went four plays for 14 yards, but a couple penalties definitely did not help them as it pushed them back late on in the game. Minute 13 to go in this halftime break. Teams are coming back out on the field. There's something I like to see down there. Some players signing autographs. One of them, Juan Moore, inactive today. He's come up on camera at all. You can see he's got a club on that right hand dealing with an injury. Fred Bruno down there signing some autographs as well. The Bandits are ready to go for the second half of play. Joshua Hollins warming up. Playing a little catch with his offensive coordinator, Scott Jensen. Oklahoma coming out of the locker room as well. Slowly but surely, we're getting ready to go for this second half. Looking at this second half of play, there's going to be some keys for both teams. Oklahoma still got to cut down on the mental mistakes. It cost them in the first half. It cost them in the first game of the season against the Bandits. That's something they're going to need to cut down on in half number two if they want to erase this 10-point deficit. Looking at it so far, for Oklahoma, they have seven penalties against them, which is almost as many already as they had in the first game, 36 yards off on those penalties. Only two against the Bandits for 10 yards, both of them coming on that last drive as well. Back-to-back plays that last drive of the first half for Sioux City. Something they're going to want to have to clean up as well. They don't want that to trickle over into half number two. Oklahoma will start with the ball here in the second half as the Bandits receive to start this game. Both teams starting to retake the field here. The officials are whistling. Trying to hurry people up, get out there on the field. Sioux City fans are getting into it. Aaron Roundtree right now pumping up the crowd. He's ready to go. Braden Mines to kick off here. They'll be kicking right to left as you see it. Mines is out there to kick. Sammy Epps with him, Zach Slugger, Jakari Christian, Landon Freeman, Xavier Spann, Aaron Roundtree as well. And Antonio Pierce rounds out the eight. Rashad Ridley, as he has been in both games against the Bandits this season for Oklahoma, he is the deep man. Kick returning specialist. Look at the special team stats so far. Ridley has two kick returns so far, 29 yards total on those two returns. One of them I remember clearly Should have been less yards, but he was able to use the fancy footwork. He receives it in his own end zone. He's going to bring it out. Gets through the middle there. Cuts off a couple tacklers. He's at the 50 to the 20. Spins away from a tackle. He's got one man to beat. Sammy Epson. Ridley's going to go and make a house call to start the second half. Worst case scenario for the Sioux City Bandits. Rashad Ridley. What's up, brother? The sketch in the end zone. Special teams, special players, special plays for Rashad Ridley as he makes a house call to make it 17-13 pending this extra point. That's one way to switch the momentum back to your side. Extra point opportunity here for Reynolds. 17-13 your score pending this extra point. Just got done talking about Rashad Ridley on the house call. Just got done talking about how dangerous he is as a returner, and immediately he takes it back for six. Hold is down, snap is good, kick up and good. It's a three-point game. Bright side for the Bandits, you're basically starting with the ball each half of play. Unfortunately, not the best-case scenario for them as their deficit was cut to three. Their lead was cut to three, I should say. 17-14. 14-12 to go in quarter number three. We'll see if the Bandits can respond. Special teams play of their own. Fred Bruno returned one for a house call in week one against the Oklahoma Flying Aces. Most likely he'll be back deep to return again. Landon Freeman's been back there with him so far. Freeman playing his first game for the Bandits. Comes from the University of Sioux Falls by way of Southern Utah. Spent time at both universities. Talked about him returning kicks in college. Go over his college stats again if you weren't here in the pregame. 204 carries at University of Sioux Falls over 2 years. 1,500 yards, 7.5 yards per carry, 18 rushing touchdowns over 2 years of play for Freeman. He's a very good running back, and he's now the backfield duo with Drew Prohaska. Reynolds tees it up. He's ready to kick off. He's back. Freeman, I should say, is back deep to return with Fred Bruno. 17-14 the score after that. Kick return for six by Rashad Ridley. Reynolds boots this one away. End over end kick going to be received deep in his own end zone by Bruno. He's looking for blocks. Cuts to his right now. Trying to answer a house call with a house call. He's got some space down the right side. He's only got the kicker to beat. He cuts back inside. Anything you can do, I can do better, says Fred Bruno. Kick return for six. It's just going to be special teams all in the second half. Scratch that. Check the emotion. There's laundry on the field to the dismay of the Bandits and their fans. It's back near the 8-yard line, and it's holding against the kick return team. Could have drove a city bus through the hole, and now we know why. Like that one, as it takes the score off the board, takes the answer off the board from Fred Bruno. Okay, it was early on in the return, too. You get a good look on the replay. That's right there as Bruno was cutting away. I believe looks like Xavier Spann's going to be the one that was called against it. What a play by Bruno. Unfortunately, all for naught for him. Hollins goes under center. Prohaska the deep back. Couple men in motion. Fakes the handoff. Does Hollins. He's looking deep downfield. Looking for Brandon Shepard. Picked off. That's going to be LeBaron Mallory. His second interception. He fumbles it, though, on the other end. It's going to be recovered, though, by Hassan Muhammad. There is a flag on the field. I think they're going to get defensive holding the way the back judge was pointing. Three big plays all in a row in this game. Two of them have been wiped out by penalties as that goes against the defense. Defensive holding saves the Bandits there. Going to move into the 15-yard line as well for Sioux City. First and 10 from their own 15. Penalty giveth, penalty taketh away for the Oklahoma Flying Aces. Sioux City's got to settle in here. It's been a highly emotional start to this half. Braden Mines checking in as a wide receiver. He's going to be in motion with Brandon Shepard. Both of them run to the line. Hollins takes the snap, handoff for Haska. Left side, he's going to get through. No, Hollins actually kept it there. I didn't even notice because he slipped in the backfield. He's going to be brought down for a loss. Hollins breaks the huddle here. After that loss, they're going to say loss of 3.5 to 4 on the play. Second and long. Hollins under center. Hand off left side. Prohaska is going to be met in the backfield. He's going to bounce off a tackle, though. Try to get back and find some space. He gains a couple yards. Still not back to the original line of scrimmage. Say they're going to just give him a yard. It's been tough running all night long for the Bandits. Rushing game has not been there. This Oklahoma defense has played very well in the run game. Very well overall, this Oklahoma defense. So we look at Sioux City, 27 yards total on the ground today. Hollins going to go in the shotgun here, third and long. Hollins sends his men to the line, takes the snap, chest high, looking right side, a little swing pass out to Prohaska, spins out of a tackle. No, he's going to get wrapped up around the leg by Hassan Muhammad. Good tackle there from Muhammad, not letting Prohaska get away, and it brings up fourth down. Fourth and about six. We'll see what the Bandits do here. They lead by 3. Offense going to stay on the field here. Fourth and 6, going to go for this one. Joshua Hollins breaks the huddle. Empty set here for Hollins. Prohaska's going to go in motion as well as Shepard. Hollins takes the snap, looks quick left side. Prohaska's there. There's a first down and more. Gets to about the 21-yard line. Drew Prohaska letting everybody know it's a first down. Good play design there. Get a couple yards clear of the line to gain. Turn around, wait in the spot. Hollins put it right on him. I say down before the 21. So first and 10 from the 22. Hollins under center again. Hand off right side, Prohaska. He's got some blocks on the right side this time. Gains a couple. And give him a game about 5. One of the longer runs of the game for Prohaska. His long was 6. That was 5. Just trying to keep that ball moving here in Sioux City. They lead 17-14. Second half, opening kickoff return for a touchdown got us to this score line. It was 17-7 at the break. Hollins takes the snap. Design quarterback run, left side. Now cuts back to the right. He's going to get a first down and more. Keeps chugging through. He's inside the red zone. Joshua Hollins. Big first down for the Bandits. It's going to bring up first and goal inside the red zone. Hollins ends his conversation with offensive coordinator Scott Jensen, now brings the play into the huddle. Epps, Bruno, and Shepard, the wide receivers. Prohaska, the running back, on the right hip pocket of Hollins, the quarterback. Clark, Fluker, and Roberts, the O-lineman. Chest high snap, another design quarterback run for Hollins. Gets a block in the middle, now cuts it off to the right side. Joshua Hollins gets near the goal line and in for 6. Joshua Hollins increases that lead back to 9 for Sioux City, potentially 10. Pending this extra point, another rushing touchdown for Joshua Hollins, the leading rusher today for Sioux City. 23-14 your score, pending this Braden Mintz extra point. Hollins having himself a very good game, his first game of the regular season. 5 for 5 to start for 68 yards and a touchdown passing. He's now 8 rushes for 28 yards and 2 touchdowns on the ground. Snap is good. No. Hold has to be picked up by Fred Bruno. Ball got away from Bruno there as he's trying to get the hold down. It's going to keep it at a 9-point game, but Josh Hollins puts him back up 2 scores here inside the Tyson Event Center with that run off the right side. 8:26 to go in the third quarter of play. When we come back, it's a media timeout here. When Oklahoma's offense comes back out on the field, they'll be led by quarterback Fred Payton Jr., who has 6 completions on 11 attempts so far, 70 yards, no touchdowns, no picks, with a long of 32. That one was caught by Zuri Davis, who has 2 catches in this game. 31 total yards, as Davis's other catch was a screen pass that was brought down behind the line of scrimmage. Looking at the rushing stats, Hassan Muhammad really broke out in that last drive of the first half for Oklahoma. 3 carries for 23 yards, all coming on that drive. Had basically all the yards on that drive as well. Fred Payton Jr., 4 carries for 6 yards from the quarterback spot. In the receiving end, we are talking about Zuri Davis, leading receiver with 2 catches for 31 yards. He's followed by C.J. French Love, 3 catches for 24 yards. And Rashad Ridley has 1 catch for 15 yards. And Ridley also had that kick return for a touchdown, going end zone to end zone. Nice to tee it up here to kick off. Back deep to return is Rashad Ridley. And I'm partly of the belief, just kick it out of bounds and start at the 20. Or if you can get it to bounce and go over the boards, start at the 5. The Deuce is also in play as well, and Mainz has the leg for it. He's got a pretty big boot. And judging from Mainz taking a short run up here, he's just going to pooch this one. Be going towards the corner of the end zone. It's going to bounce in the end zone off the boards. Ridley is going to pick it up. He's out past the 5 to the 10. Cuts back inside. He's tripped up from behind. Brought down at about the 12-yard line. Player lost his helmet for Sioux City. That's Landon Freeman. He's not a defensive player, but he will have to step off. First and 10 now from the 11-yard line, I want to say, here for Oklahoma. See what the Flying Aces have here. Their first offensive possession of half number 2, down 9. When you start off the half receiving the kick down 10, and the first time you're taking a snap at quarterback, you're down 9, you know something weird's happened. But Fred Payton Jr. on the read option up the middle, makes a couple men miss. Now he's breaking off an arm tackle. Eventually he's going to be brought down by a pack of bandits. Groenhagen was in there as well as Mainz and Xavier Spann, but not before he got a gain of about 6. Gosh, they're going to mark him just short of that and make a 5-yard gain. ...23-14. Payton Jr.'s had a good showing at quarterback in his first action for Oklahoma. Started out absolutely on fire. It was 4-for-6 at one point. He's cooled off since then. He's 2 for his last 5. And the running game started to come on late. This is going to be a pass, though, from Payton. He's looking deep down the field. He's got Rashad Ridley. Does he have a man beat? Oh, it's just out of reach of Rashad Ridley. The diving effort made. Looks like it went right between the arms as he was diving out for it. And Ridley, not something you want to see if you're an Oklahoma fan. He gets up limping. I tweaked that left ankle as he was going down trying to catch that one. Ridley's going to take a couple plays off. Hope to see him back out there. No matter who you're a fan of, he's an electric player. Players like Ridley make you want to watch the NAL. That is for sure. Shotgun formation here for Fred Payton. Hassan Muhammad, the running back, on his left side. Zuri Davis going to go in motion, as well as C.J. French Love. Payton takes the snap, chest high, looking left, now goes back right, over the middle, looking for French Love. Coverage on that play by Xavier Spann. The pass is going to be incomplete. French Love wants a flag. Doesn't look like he's going to get one. Fourth down here coming. Thank you. Fourth down here means an empty set for this Oklahoma offense. They trail by nine. They're going to go for this one deep in their own territory. Built high, snap, looking downfield, now forced to scramble as Fred Payton Jr. He's got enough space to try to get it. He's met hard at the line to gain by Carlton Watkins, and he was laid out by Watkins. They're going to stay a yard short as well. It looks like it's going to be first and 10 for the Bandits. Carlton Watkins laid an absolute boomstick on the quarterback. He was crawling on the down like a dog. You're letting them know you got that dog in you. Big play from Watkins there. Brings up a first and 10 for the Bandits. The defense stands tall. First and 10 from basically the 20-yard line. Caught at the 21. Under center goes Hollins. Prohaska the deep back. Bruno and Shepard going to go in motion. Bruno wraps through. Jet sweep motion. Handoff to Prohaska, though. Left side gets a couple. The stick still says fourth down, but this is a fresh set for the Bandits. A couple players are talking. They are separated. Hassan Muhammad rushing in there to make sure his teammate doesn't get in any trouble. Second down and about eight here for the Bandits. Holland's going to go in the shotgun. Prohaska on his left. Three receivers split out wide to the right. We'll see if any wrap out left. Bruno and Epps going to be in motion. No, they stay right side. Low snap picked up by Hollins, looking for Fred. Bruno in the end zone. Bruno snags it. That's a touchdown. He almost ends up in the lap of a fan in the front row. But Fred Bruno gets his get back for that touchdown they took off the board earlier due to a holding. 29-14 now. Sioux City leads by 15 pending this extra point. Could move it to a 16-point game here. Emotions are running high down there on the field. Right now it's just exchanging of some maybe not so pleasantries. Prohaska running off late there. Mainz to kick, Bruno to hold. Could make it 30-14. Low snap, bobbled by Bruno. He gets it up, kick wide to the right from Mainz. Had to stutter on his run up a little bit as Bruno was trying to get that bobbled snap. Makes it 29-14. It'll stay a 15-point game, but the Bandits back on top by double digits here inside the Tyson Event Center. 3:20 to go in quarter number three after Fred Bruno got behind the defense and found his way into the end zone for six. But let's talk about Joshua Hollins. 6 for 6, 86 yards and 2 touchdowns for the quarterback. He's also the leading rusher with 28 yards on the ground and 2 touchdowns there as well. This has been quite a performance from Hollins leading this Bandits offense. Okay, we're going to get another media timeout here in the third quarter of play. 29-14, your score. We'll see the kick team for Sioux City. We'll see if Rashad Ridley is back healthy. He did limp off the field earlier on. We'll see all that after some fan engagement here inside the Tyson Event Center. As the kick return team is coming out for Oklahoma, Rashad Ridley is back out there. Whatever he tweaked, he's okay. Actually, he's talking to one of his coaches right now. Might be pleading his case that he is okay. And they're actually going to make him step off. So he's pleading his case that he's okay. Coaches want to make sure he is. Give him a little more of a breather. So back deep to return is Hassan Muhammad. Something you like to see from a coaching staff. Sometimes you do got to protect the guys from themselves. Just give Ridley a little more of a breather. He's a key player. They could need him down the stretch, not only in this game, but in this season. No need to risk him right now in this very moment on a kick return. Mainz to kick it away. Looks like it's going to be another short run up for Mainz. Low driven kick bounces at their own 20, bouncing all the way into the arms of Hassan Muhammad. He's up the middle of the field, now cuts right side. He's got a little bit of a space, but he's brought down, excuse me there on that hiccup, brought down by Jakari Christian. First one of those in a long time here on a Sioux City Bandits broadcast. My apologies there. 29-14 your score, 3:06 to go and counting in the third quarter of play. It's going to be first and 10 from the Bandits, 20. Great starting field position after that kick return from Hassan Muhammad. Huddle is broken here. Fred Payton Jr. in the shotgun. 6-13 on the day for the quarterback. Started hot, but the passing game hasn't really been clicking as of late. See if they can get that on track. Have to wait a little longer, though, to see it. Hand off to Hassan Muhammad, left side. Devin Groenhagen's there, and he's ripping him down. Eventually, Randall Blash gets in there as well. Devin Groenhagen, though, the long arm of the law won't let him get away. Makes it second down from the 23-yard line. So second and 13 after that tackle for loss. Maybe close to a second and 14. The first negative run of the day for Muhammad. Had that momentum going at the end of the first half in the running game. Now it's a looks like a passing down here for Payton. He's going to take the snap. Couple step drop, now he's firing towards the end zone. Zuri Davis is there, catches it at the 5. He's whipped up along the boards and pushed out of play by Carlton Watkins. Great route run, though, by Zuri Davis to get that that separation. The ball was put right on him by Fred Payton Jr. High points it does, Davis. Eventually knocked up along the boards by Carlton Watkins just before he can stretch that ball out for 6. First and goal from looks like the 1-yard line here for Oklahoma. They went to a power formation earlier on, got their first touchdown of the game from that. The other touchdown came on special teams. Kick return for 6 from Rashad Ridley. Shotgun formation here for Payton. Running back on his right is Muhammad. Sends a couple men to the line, hand off Muhammad, left side. He's going to be stuffed at the line of scrimmage. Still got the legs moving, trying to push into the end zone. No whistles blowing from the referee. The ball came out. Someone's got it for the Bandits. No whistle blown. Still eventually brought down. The whistle never blew. Antonio Pierce is the one who ends up with the ball. Didn't see who ripped it away, but it's going to be first and 10 for the Bandits from their own 5-yard line. That's that gray area of referee discretion, where sometimes you can blow that play dead early and the offense gets mad at you for not letting their running back keep churning the legs. On the other side of that coin, you upset the offense when you don't call the player and his momentum stopped early, and you have that happen. It's a catch-22. That's why you couldn't pay me enough to be an official. Carlton Watkins coming off the field. I think he yelled, "I'm the best in the game." Hard to disagree with him with his performance so far today. He's been playing very well for this Sioux City Bandits team. Looking at his stats today, 4 tackles now, 1 TFL, 1 pass breakup. He might have been the one in there to help rip it away, but the fumble was recovered by Antonio Pierce. A couple of Sioux City offensive linemen were making a flag motion, like they wanted a flag throw. I don't know if somebody was saying something on the Oklahoma defense. We're back to get ready to go. Hollins takes the snap. Wide receivers were across the line before the snap was given. So it'll back him up halfway to their own goal line. Another flag flies late, though, after the official was announcing the first penalty. Penalty flags are brought to you by Flanzone. Looks like there was some jaw-jacking after the play, and there's going to be an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty against Oklahoma. Richard Davis not happy with that call. Judging by some reactions, it might have been on Coach Davis as he is now back to the bench. Not out on the field, still barking orders to his team. First and 10 now for the Bandits from their own 20 after all the penalties are said and done. Hollins takes the snap, chest high. Looking for options, now he's going to take off and run. Right side, little spin move, trying to get some more yards. Gain of 4, brings up 2nd and 6. Second and 6 from their own 24-yard line for the Bandits. And it looks like we're going to let time run out in this third quarter of play. We're heading to the fourth. 29-14, Sioux City leads over the Oklahoma Flying Aces. 15-point advantage for the Bandits. What a performance so far from quarterback Joshua Hollins. Didn't get the start today, but took over and has been exceptional. Four fingers up. The Bandits are ready for quarter number 4, and we are too here with more National Arena League football. Thank you for joining us this evening. I am Braden Butler. Got some confirmation there as we are heading back to the fourth quarter of play. That unsportsmanlike near the end of the third quarter was against Coach Davis. That's why he has been sent to the sidelines here. I know him and Coach Irv Strobien are both mic'd up for around the NAL. Duqan Williams, who's here, as there's a pass left side to Sammy Epps, gets through his hands. It was too low for him, trying to bend down to get that one. If you're familiar with around the NAL, you know, it's a weekly show that takes you around the NAL. It's kind of in the name, really fitting. Review the week before, preview the week ahead. Coach Williams and Coach Strobien were on last week. They both agreed to be mic'd up for this game. Duqan Williams, the host of that show, is here today, actually, filming highlights in person. Catch that in the next week review. Hollins now in an empty set. 3rd and 6 after the drop pass. Now he runs up the middle, trying to cut it out left side. Hollins comes up just a yard short, and it looks like Coach Strobien, letting Hollins know if you just keep going north and south, maybe you get some contact. You don't have a chance at the touchdown if you don't break it outside, but if you keep going north-south, maybe you get that fresh set of downs, you can get a touchdown on another play. Now it's 4th and 1, clock running, 14 minutes to go in this fourth quarter. Oklahoma Flying Aces trail the Sioux City Bandits 29-14. Hollins going to go under center here, 4th and 1. Prohaska the deep back. Bruno and Shepard going to go in motion. Jet sweep, Bruno, right side. Got some space, gets the fresh set. Slips down, though, but he's eventually touched down after a couple yards rolling on the turf. Bruno upset with himself after the turf monster was the only one that could stop him on that play. But it is a fresh set of downs for the Bandits. 1st and 10 from the Oklahoma 18-yard line. Hollins going under center again. Prohaska still the deep back. Same basic formation. Shepard and Bruno going to go in motion. Another jet sweep. No, fakes it, pitches it out to Prochazka. There's a flag thrown in the backfield. Prochazka is going to get nothing on the play. We'll see who this penalty's on. Penalties are brought to you by Flanzone. Flans Electronics. Going to get a hold against the offense. And replay first down. And I say that's against number 55. That's Omar Roberts. Hollins gets the play call. Chico, that incomplete pass earlier this drive was Hollins' first of the game. He's now 6-for-7 for 86 yards and 2 touchdowns. Hollins going to go under center here. Second and very long. Fakes the handoff in the middle. He's going to bootleg out to the right. He's looking downfield. Fred Bruno's there. Corner of the end zone looking for him. Does not get him. It bounces over the boards. And Fred Bruno, who was balanced on the boards, was trying to get back in the field of play. He got an extra shove, tipped him back over a little bit by LeBaron Mallory. And that is the kind of mental mistake Oklahoma can't have, especially when they got the band is backed up on what would have been a third and very long. That's going to be another unsportsmanlike, it looks like, against Oklahoma. It's going to be the first unsportsmanlike against Mallory. So it's going to bring up first and 10 now for the Bandits at about the Oklahoma 13-yard line. Whistles blow. Get another meeting of the minds with the officials. Waiting on some sort of ruling. Josh Hollins is going to use this time to talk to his head coach, Irv Strobien. Fred Bruno going to use the time to dap up a couple fans on the stands. Still waiting on the officials. So it's going to be first and 10 from the 14 now. Everything spotted okay. Everybody's ready to go, I hope. Back to action. Joshua Hollins in the shotgun. Prochazka on his left hip pocket. Bruno out wide to the left. Shepard in the right. They're both in motion. Hollins takes the snap. Little quick fire pass. He'll pitch out to Drew Prochazka down the left sideline. He's knocked up along the boards. Prochazka was looking for the end zone. He's knocked out just short, but a good run there from Drew Prochazka. Hollins. Almost looked like a design speed option there. Good read by Hollins. He stood in there and took a pop too as he was pitching it. First and goal now for the Sioux City Bandits from the three-yard line they're going to give him there. Now we're going to go shotgun here, Hollins. Prochazka on his left, Bruno and Shepard in motion. Bruno's going to wrap around, three receivers to the right now. Timeout taken. Offensive coordinator Scott Jensen wanted to talk about something. Doesn't look happy. I don't know if it was with how they were set up or the fact that the play clock was winding down. Coach Strobien and Coach Jensen both talking to the team right now. Got a pat on the back of the helmet from Coach Strobien, did Josh Hollins. Good relationship between a head coach and a quarterback is crucial at any level of the game. And Coach Strobien has been known for years to have a very good relationship with his players. But it's way better than that. That was 100th career win last week, did Coach Strobeam. Credited putting the right guys around him. He's been working with Coach Defensive Coordinator Marlon Loban for years. Coached Offensive Coordinator Scott Jensen for years, now in his second year as Offensive Coordinator. There haven't been many Sioux City Bandits teams that have not involved Irv Strobeam as a player or a coach. 100 career wins in arena football. Right now, all he cares about is 101. 29-14, your score. Sioux City leads Oklahoma with 11:26 to go in the fourth. Holland's under center, Prohaska the deep back. Bruno and Epps in motion. They're on the right side of the formation. Quick pass, a little back shoulder fade looking for Brandon Shepard. It's going to be caught by a fan who is field side. A lot of hand fighting between Brandon Shepard and the defensive back there. Fans happy with his souvenir. Don't know if he realizes how close he was to a Bandits player in his lap. Young fan just gave the Dikembe Mutombo finger wag to an Oklahoma player. Good to see a young fan be a student of the game and know Dikembe Mutombo, I hope. Holland's under center, Bruno in motion, wrapping around. Shepard joins him, quick pass out right side. Sammy Epps, he's got some blockers in front of him on the screen. He dives into the end zone for six. 35-14, now your score. Sioux City leads. And Joshua Holland celebrating with his wide receiver, Sammy Epps. That's a big play for the Bandits. They increase their lead to 21, pending the extra point. 7-for-10 now is Josh Holland. Three touchdown passes. He's also got two touchdowns rushing for 37 yards. High snap, Bruno gets it down. Mines with the kick up just wide to the left, no good. So it's gonna be 35-14. The flag is gonna fly after the play. Brandon Shepard letting his opinions be known about it. I think they're gonna get him on a late hit here as he tackled the defensive player who received it off the rebound nets. 35-14 your score, pending the extra point. Maybe a little bit of a teaching moment from Coach Strobeam here. Epps, who could have had a touchdown on the first play of this game, gets his six on the board there. 35-14. And it's up 21. Coach Strobeam still talking to the officials. Maybe wanting more clarification on the call. Mines to kick off here, back deep to return. It is Hassan Muhammad. Still no Rashad Ridley. Left this game earlier on, tweaked his ankle a little bit. Tried to come back into the game, but was sat back down by the coaching staff. Last thing you want to do is make that injury worse to one of your key players. Low driven kick, bounces about the 23 into the arms of Hassan. Hassan Muhammad gets past the 20. He's going to be wrapped up and swung down hard. It's going to be Zach Slugger in there on the tackle.
Slugger on the tackle.
First and 10. First and 10 for Oklahoma, but they still got to add on those that penalty yardage from the extra point. Marching off the penalty yardage now. It's going to be first and 10 from key field position for Oklahoma. Once the herd stops moving. First and 10 from the 14 of the Bandits. 14 yards to go if the Flying Aces want to answer with six. Empty set. Actually going to be a handoff. Hassan Muhammad went around, swung around, and then brought down by Devin Groenhagen. Groenhagen strutting his stuff. Second and 11 now from the 15-yard line for Oklahoma. 8:44 and counting to go in the fourth quarter of play. A whistle's going to blow and timeout's going to be taken here. There was one other game going on tonight in the National Arena League. Haven't talked about it much. Carolina taking on Colorado. Close game out in Greensboro. The Cobras defeated the Spartans 44-35. The Cobras move to 3-1 on the season, while the Spartans fall to 0-2. Spartans are 0-2 along with the Horsemen now. The Flying Aces in danger of going 0-2. The Bandits are still at 1-0, could go to 2-0 with a win. The Cobras now at 3-1, have the most wins, but are third in the league as it stands. And the Omaha Beef, top of the league right now, could be tied with the Bandits after this one if Sioux City wins. The Beef are at 2-0. Empty set here for Peyton. Takes the snap at his own, at the 20-yard line of the Bandits. Flag is going to fly. Peyton's going to try to find some space down the right sideline. He's shoved up along the boards by Aaron Roundtree out of play. Decent gain is going to make it third and short depending on this penalty. And judging by the little dance that Coach Loban was doing, it might be against the offense. Now he looks upset about it. Trying to read the body language of Coach Loban. He's very expressive. It's easy to read sometimes. Whenever I need to know an exact feeling of a call, I just look to Coach Lowe. The official's still talking. Talking to Coach Davis. They're telling him where the ball would be spotted if they decline the penalty compared to where it would be if they accept it. So they're going to accept the penalty and keep the down. So after all the confusion, it's 2nd and 6 for Oklahoma at the 10-yard line of the Bandits. At the edge of the red zone, but not a goal-to-goal situation. Empty set for Peyton again, sends a couple men to the line. He's looking left. Forced to step out to his right, spinning back. He's near the midfield stripe, and he slips down. Ossie Tapua is going to get the sack. That might have been more than three. Key and Peel might have to throw a flag on that one. 35-14, though. The Bandits leading, and now they have the Oklahoma Flying Aces in tough territory. Third and long from their own 24-yard line. Third and 20, it looks like, for Oklahoma. Good pressure applied by Sioux City trying to turn it into something was Fred Payton. Unfortunately, got tripped up by the Turf Monster. Sack was completed by Ossie Tapua. Going to be empty set here for Payton. Got to assume. They're going to try to get at least half of this back. It looks like four down territory, down 21 for Oklahoma. Try to get some of it back here. Peyton, forget that, looking for the end zone. High point, trying to get the ball. It's not going to be caught. Hassan Muhammad was there. He was trying to go for it in the back of the end zone. Almost got it, too. There's a couple Bandits defenders there. One of them, Jakari Christian. This is a wide receiver playing corner right now. Antonio Pierce was back there as well. Fourth and long for Oklahoma. A field goal doesn't really do you much. They're going to be looking end zone here, most likely. Basically looking end zone. You need to get to the 4-yard line for a first down. Be easier to end up in the end zone at this point, it seems, than to try to find that sweet spot in between the goal line and the line to gain. Rashad Ridley back out there on the field. Good to see him. Keep an eye on him for this Oklahoma team. 3 seconds on the play clock. 2-1. Do they get it off in time? They do not. No, Richard Davis called a timeout for his team. First time out of the half for Oklahoma comes with 6:24 to go in the fourth quarter. 35-14, your score. Sioux City leading here. Teams back out on the field for this fourth and long, and it looks like Coach Davis is just going to try to get three here, at least kick this away. Reynolds to kick. Ball's going to be spotted at the 24. Holt's going to get down at about the 19. 25, 6, 41, plus about 8. They're going to be between 47 and 50 yards on this field goal attempt. Check that. My math was way off, but I digress. Kick here from Reynolds is high, drifting towards the uprights, and it is dead center. That's going to be three on the board, and it knocks the ball down that was stuck earlier. Blessing in disguise for the fans in the stands. It looks like Bruno's trying to find someone to give a new souvenir to. Everybody in the crowd rises to their feet, and he found someone. So there's two souvenirs now. Good news for the fans. Not great news for the Bandits, as 3 points are on the board for Oklahoma. Lead is still 35-17. Would have been 37-40 yarder there, give or take. No matter what, it was good from Reynolds. I'm going to say officially from 39 yards out for Jeremy Reynolds. Good kick there, 35-17, the first field goal of the game for Oklahoma. They do trail by 18 here. It's still a three-score game. Last thing you want to do, though, is try to give the Bandits good field position, especially with the way this offense has been performing as of late. Josh Holland, 7-for-10 for 90 yards and 3 touchdowns at the quarterback position. He's also got 10 carries for 37 yards and 2 touchdowns on the ground. Drew Prohaska, 8 carries for 29 yards. He's also leading receiver at 4 catches for 39 yards. Brandon Shepard, Fred Bruno, and Sammy Epps have the 3 touchdown catches. 2 catches for 38 yards and that touchdown for Shepard. 2 catches for 22 yards and the touchdown for Bruno. Epps, 1 catch, 4 yards. He got that one in for 6. I wish we could get a camera on Braden Pints right now. Strutting his stuff down there on the field. There it is. As Billie Jean by Michael Jackson comes over the loudspeakers inside the Tyson Event Center. That's one way to get anybody moving. There aren't many songs that can unify the masses quite like Billie Jean. 6:21 to go in quarter number four. 35-17, Sioux City leads. Reynolds tees it up in his own end zone. Back deep to return for the Bandits is Fred Bruno. A lot of players up near the line. They're expecting a onside or something of the like. A little trickery from Oklahoma. And it's going to be a low German kick. It's going to go off of Sammy Epps. It's going to be recovered by the Flying Aces. A flag is going to fly, though. Flanzone penalty flag. We'll see who it's on as it stands. Oklahoma has possession of the ball. And Braden Mintz was reminding a couple Oklahoma players as he points at the flag. This one might be against the Flying Aces. The laundry has not been kind to Oklahoma today. They have that. They and I have something in common there. It's like an Oklahoma player crossed the line before the kick was off. Now they're going to flip sides here. They're going to try kicking it from the other side. No, they're just going to talk to Coach Davis. Smart play. Kicker Reynolds kicked it as hard as he could at the first bandit he could find. It bounced off of him, and they recovered it at Oklahoma. Reynolds tees it up again, same spot as before. See what they have here. He's taking his time setting this one up. Reynolds, this one more of a traditional onside kick, gets it to bounce up. Carlton Watkins just comes down with it and brings it in near the 24-yard line. There is another flag on the play. Can't make another joke about my laundry at home, can I? I digress. We'll see what the officials have to say here about this one. ...35-17, the score in this fourth quarter of play. These kickoff attempts have been marred by penalty flags. Another offside on the kickoff against Oklahoma. It's going to bring up first and 10 for the Bandits. It was recovered about their own 24, so after the penalties marched off, they're going to say actually it was covered at the midfield stripe, so after the penalty is marched off, first and 10 from the 15-yard line. Hollins going to line up under center. It's a power formation. We saw this the first drive of the game. Mainz is a fullback. Freeman and Prohaska, the deep running backs, split wide to the left. It's going to be a power sweep to Freeman. He's going to put the shoulder down, truck through one defender, get a couple more yards off of it, gain of about three or four. Landon Freeman, a new signing for this Bandits team. Giving Drew Prohaska a buddy in the backfield. Bandits in the past couple years have fluctuated between a 2-1 running back system. Last year it was predominantly just Prohaska. Year before that, if you remember back to 2022 at this point, it was Prohaska and Kamal Cass in the backfield. Looks like they're going to run the same play. Other side, this time to Prohaska. There's going to be another flag on the play. Prohaska trying to bounce it outside, gets a couple yards. Another penalty flag. I see two pieces of laundry on the field. Josh Hollins is excited about it. See who these flags are on. 5 minutes to go in the fourth quarter of play. It's 35-17. Sioux City leads Oklahoma. So the penalties offset is there's one against the defense and one against the offense. The motion man was in the box. So I think Mainz is asking for clarification on if it was him or Freeman who was in motion that the penalty was called on, because Mainz was trying to explain to Freeman how that rule works. Mainz being a very experienced at this level now with the Bandits for the last few years. Freeman in his first game for Sioux City. It's hard to learn all the ins and outs of the arena game on the fly. Going to get timeout for Sioux City here. It's their third and final timeout of the second half. 4:40 to go in the fourth quarter of play, 35-17. Bandits lead by 18. Oklahoma's offense started off well. 7 points immediately on that opening drive. But 35 points now on the board for Sioux City, compared to only 10 since then for Oklahoma. Defense has stepped up for the Bandits. Forced a couple turnovers. Downs, I should say. There's the one fumble recovery by Antonio Pierce as well. Leading the Bandits defense right now is Devin Groenhagen. Six tackles, three of them for loss. Braden Mines has five tackles. Carlton Watkins has four, one of them for loss, and one pass breakup as well. Hassan Muhammad, the leading tackler right now for Oklahoma. He's at 10 on the game. Got a chance for more here as he's still out there on the field. Little player split out wide to the right. Oh, it's going to be a fake on the play. They just ran, and it's going to go for six as Brandon Shepard high points the ball off the head top of Hassan Muhammad, and he takes that one in for six. They ran the play to the left. They ran the play to the right. It was called for a penalty, and then they fake the play and lob it up to their big play threat, Brandon Shepard, and they get in for six. 41-17, pending the extra point with 4:34 to go in this fourth quarter of play. Joshua Hollins has this offense absolutely humming right now for Sioux City. Mines to kick the extra point here. Fred Bruno to hold. Snap is good. Hold is down. Mines extra point up and is good. Replay that high point ball by Brandon Shepard, tapping the top of his head, letting him know he got off the head top of the defensive back. 4:34 to go in quarter number four. Sioux City leads 42-17 after that touchdown. Brandon Shepard, a man of the people, celebrating with some fans in the stands as well. See what Sioux City does here. I should say we see what the Oklahoma offense does here. They're the ones that got to put a lot of points on the board in a short amount of time. 4:34 to go in the fourth. Sioux City leads 42-17. Josh Holland's stats on the day, 8-for-11 passing, 102 yards, four touchdowns, and then you add the ground game. He's the leading rusher at 37 yards with two touchdowns there as well. Brandon Shepard, the new leading receiver on the team with 50 yards on three catches, two of them for six. Coming into today's game, he had 33 touchdown receptions in 33 career games for the Bandits. And he has two in his first of 2024. Did not play in week one against Oklahoma. This is his season debut. Mainz boots this one. Rashad Ridley back to return. It's good to see him back out there on kick returns. Takes it in his own end zone. Trying to find some space. Gets away from an arm tackle. Now cutting it back to the right side. He's wrapped up. No, gets away from Jakari Christian. Eventually, he's going to be brought down. Constant pressure by the Bandits was too much. Antonio Pierce eventually gets him at the 10-yard line. Rashad Ridley, though, showing why he is one of the most dangerous return men in the entire league. Honestly, regardless of league. One of the most dangerous men on the return in any league in indoor arena football. See what Oklahoma has drawn up here. First and 10 from their own 10-yard line. Empty set here. Looks like Davis and Torrance Carr-Young are going to be in motion as the receivers. Takes the snap, looking right side, finds Zuri Davis. It's going to be enough for the first down as he gets pushed up along the boards. Aaron Roundtree was in there as well as Jakari Christian. Enough for a new set of downs, though, so it does not change from first and 10. First and 10 from the 22-yard line here. Empty set again for Fred Payton. He's 8-for-16 through the air. Going to go back to the air on this one. Looking quick left side has Rashad Ridley. He's lit up by Carlton Watkins. Good catch, better tackle. It's going to be second down here from the 25-yard line. Get him at the 24 here. Empty set here again for Peyton. We're under 3 minutes to go, under 2.5 minutes to go now in the fourth quarter. Peyton takes the snap, looking deep. Now has to roll out to his right, looking for more options. Checks it down to Torrance Carr-Young. He's going to have enough for a first down. Wrapped up by Aussie Tapua. It looks like Tapua was trying to rip that ball out. First and 10 here. Just down the edge of the red zone for Oklahoma. Under 2 minutes to go in this fourth quarter play. Oklahoma's got to hustle up here. Trailing by 25. It's a four-score game at least. Hand off to Bingham on the jet sweep off the left side. He's going to be wrapped up from behind by Randall Blash. Eventually gets brought down. Able to fall forward, though, is Bingham. He's going to bring up second down inside the red zone now for Oklahoma. Sioux City defense doesn't want to give anything up here. Even with the big lead, they don't want another score on the board for Oklahoma at all. Snap taken by Peyton, looking over the middle of the field, has a man open. It is caught for six. That's a touchdown there for C.J. French Love. His fourth catch of the game, goes for six, makes it 42-23. 19-point ball game, pending the extra point with 56 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. It may not seem like it right now, but I remember a game right here in this building 2 years ago between the Bandits and the Beef, where there were 20 points scored in the last 30 seconds of the ballgame. Extra point up, extra point good. What I'm trying to say is nothing is ever really out of reach in arena football. As now it is 42-24, Oklahoma trails by 18. We get our final media timeout here as we go to the 1 minute warning. Final 56 seconds of play here in Sioux City. Oklahoma's going to try to go for an onside kick here. They do have two timeouts, but if the Bandits get it back, you got to assume they're just going to take the air out of the ball up 42-24. Final 56 seconds has in store. Let's look at these stats. I haven't given a lot of love to the defense of late. Let's look at the defensive stats for both teams. Hassan Muhammad leading the Flying Aces with 10 tackles. Karan Bolden has 6 tackles, 1 sack. 3 of those tackles were for loss. Darian Clark and Leon Smalls each have 6 tackles as well. Devin Groenhagen has 6 tackles to lead the Bandits, 3 of those for loss. Carlton Watkins and Braden Mines right behind him with 5 tackles each. One of those tackles for loss for Watkins and another pass breakup for Watkins as well. Antonio Pierce and Aussie Tapua have 4 tackles each, 1 sack and 1 TFL for Tapua. Slugger's got 3 tackles with a pass breakup. Justin Gilbert has 3 tackles as well. So a couple of different strategies for kickoffs here from Reynolds. See what they have drawn up here for Oklahoma. This one, they're just going to boot downfield to Fred Bruno. He's going to receive it outside of his own end zone. Takes his time, being the patience, finds a gap. He's eventually going to be brought up and pushed along the boards right in front of the Sioux City bench. Fred Bruno, the franchise, gets him to the 22-yard line for first and 10. 50 seconds to go for the Bandits. There are 2 timeouts for Oklahoma. We'll see how the offense approaches this for Sioux City. They've been showing the ability to run here in the later stages of this game. See what Scott Jensen has drawn up, what Josh Hollins brings into the huddle. assume a first down will basically wrap this game up. And they're going to go power formation. Gronhagen, the fullback. The deep back split in the backfield are Prochaska and Mainz. Hollins, handoff up the middle. Prochaska cuts it out right side. Gain of about 4 on that one. Gets to the 25-yard line. No timeout being signaled for by Oklahoma. With a 1 second difference between the play clock and the game clock, one more play will have to be run here by Sioux City. 42-24 your score. Looks like both teams are content to let the sun set on this one. The Bandits will have to run one more play. I've never seen a victory formation in indoor football. See what Hollins has here. 5 seconds to go on the play clock. He goes under center. Handoff. And they're just going to, Collins is going to fall forward for a yard. And that is going to do it here from the Tyson Event Center in Sioux City. The Bandits move to 2-0 on the year with a 42-24 victory over the Oklahoma Flying Aces. The Bandits went down early 7-0 in that first quarter, but held the Flying Aces just 17 points the rest of the game. Outscoring them 14-0 in the second, 12-7 in the third, and then 13-10 in the final period. 42-24, your final score. Let's look at the final stats for both these teams. Let's take a look at what's next for Sioux City. They got a quick turnaround. They're right back here next week, are the Bandits. First of all, let's look at your stats in this one. Your final stats will start on offense with the Oklahoma Flying Aces. Fred Payton Jr. went 11 for 19 for 125 yards and a touchdown in this one. Hassan Muhammad, 6 carries for 19 yards with the leading rusher for Oklahoma. Fred Payton Jr. right behind him, 6 carries for 15 yards. Zuri Davis, the leading receiver, 4 catches for 64 yards. Big play threat yet again, as he was a key factor when these two teams met in week one. He had 2 catches for 34 yards and a touchdown back then. So with some quick math, he has 6 catches for 98 yards and a touchdown against the Sioux City Bandits this season. It's a great game in the receiving department for Davis. C.J. French Love had 4 catches for 30 yards and a touchdown as well. Rashad Ridley had 2 catches for 20 yards. Also had that kick return for a touchdown for Ridley. Torrance Carr-Young, 1 catch for 11 yards. Looking at the Bandits' stats, we'll start in the rushing game. Josh Hollins had 11 carries for 38 yards and 2 touchdowns. Drew Prochaska had 9 carries for 32 yards and also 4 catches for 39 yards for Prochaska. Brandon Shepard was the leading receiver with 50 yards and 2 touchdowns on 3 catches. Fred Bruno had 2 catches for 22 yards and a touchdown. And Sammy Epps had 1 catch for 4 yards and a touchdown. We saved one man for last on his stats. Well, we already gave you part of him in the rushing category. I probably shouldn't have buried the lead there, but I digress. Joshua Hollins is your offensive player of the game for the Sioux City Bandits. 8 for 11 for 102 yards and 4 touchdowns through the air. Add in those 38 yards and 2 touchdowns on the ground. He was the driving force in this win today for the Sioux City Bandits. He is your offensive player of the game. Let's look at the defensive stats now for both teams. Hassan Muhammad led the team in tackles for Oklahoma with 10 on the day. Caron Bolden had 8 tackles, 1 sack, 3 tackles for loss. Leon Smalls and Darian Clark each had 6 tackles. Arnell Anderson had 5. The Barry Mallory had 4. Lionel Wiggins had 3. The Keith Murray, Austin Jones, Corey Tucker each had 1. Devin Gronhagen, the leading tackler for Sioux City, 6 total tackles, 3 of them for loss. Carlton Watkins, 5 tackles, 1 TFL, 1 pass breakup. Another 5 tackles for Braden Mainz. 4 tackles each for Antonio Pierce and Asi Tapua, with a sack and a TFL as well for Tapua. 3 tackles for Slugger and Gilbert. Ja'Kari Christian, Xavier Spann, Randall Blash each had 2 tackles. And lastly, Sammy Epps and the quarterback. Josh Hollins was out there on kick coverage early on in this game. Before he stepped in at quarterback, he had a tackle along with Epps. Defensive player of the game is going to be the long arm of the law today. Devin Gronhagen, 6 tackles, 3 of them for loss, led this Bandits defense. A guy who at the end of last season announced his retirement. I don't know if it was convincing from the organization or he just had that itch to come back. But Devin Gronhagen is a big part of this Bandits defense this season. He will be for the rest of the year, and it's good to see him back in a Sioux City uniform. He is your defensive player of the game in this one. 42-24, your final score. Let's take a look at what's next for these Sioux City Bandits. They're back in action next week right here in Sioux City, Iowa. At the Tyson Event Center, they host the Colorado...